Well, the McDonald's game is the gold standard of high school all-star games. Every player dreams about being in this game.
Number 23.
Lobs to Garnett for the dunk. We are witnessing greatness.
Welcome to the 2015 McDonald's All-American Game from Chicago, Illinois. Fifth consecutive year we are at the United Center. This game has been played every year since 1978. We see 24 of the best high school basketball players in the country as the East meets the West. Delighted to be courtside with Chicago lineup tonight. Adam Amin, a couple of ex-McDonald's All-Americans, Jay Williams, Jalen Rose. You guys know how important this game is, how important this game can be, not just for these guys, but for everybody watching.
A celebration of greatness, a reward for your hard work. And this is an interesting time because baseball hasn't started. We're forcing a lot of football topics, even though the season doesn't start until September. Pay attention to the stars of tomorrow. Tonight.
I think we need more of me in the background here.
Yeah, we don't have enough, clearly.
You know what? You know why you come to a game like this? You come to a game like this to be part of this. Be part. Look at that. Look at Jay Rose right there.
Yes, indeed.
The Fab Five, right? I mean, that's how you come to games like, to be a part of greatness. And you know what? We're going to get a chance to see the next Fab Five. I'm not saying there's going to be another Fab Five, but the next players in this generation to take this game to a new level.
Number two player in the country, still undeclared. One of eight undeclared players. Jaylen Brown was awesome yesterday.
I'm a huge fan. It was almost like the last year. For me, it was Emmanuel Mudiay last year and Stanley Johnson. This gentleman is like a combination of the two. Competes on the defensive end, picks up 94 feet. You see the athleticism finishing over the top. A knockdown three-point shooter off catch and off dribble will be a special player.
Jaylen Brown and Ben Simmons were by far the best players here yesterday in the scrimmage. And Ben Simmons, Ben I Am Simmons is what I call him. 6'9", 225 pounds. They call him Mr. Versatility. He is great, can rebound a basketball, extremely athletic, has big-time vision, good athleticism. This makes everybody else around him better.
He's going to LSU. He's talking with Quinn Kestick now.
Ben, how do you handle the pressure that goes along with being the number one player in the country?
To me, there's no pressure. You know, I don't allow myself to put pressure on myself. I'm here to have fun. I'm in Chicago Bulls Arena on ESPN, so I'm ready to play.
A lot of fans across the country watching you for the first time. What do you hope they see?
Just my versatility. I'm trying to put on the show with, you know, Blakeney, Jaylen Brown, but we're going to have fun.
Good luck. Adam.
Starting lineups for tonight and the East. Brown, the top undeclared recruit. Blakeney, a teammate of Ben Simmons, going to LSU. Isaiah Briscoe's the only Kentucky commit in this game. Diamond Stone's going to Maryland. Here's the rest of the East roster as well. Duke represented by one of the best pure shooters in the country in Luke Kennard. Two very good undeclared bigs in Shek Diallo and Thomas Bryant. Meanwhile, for the West, Brandon Ingram can fill it up. P.J. Dozier can fill it up. Malik Newman can fill it up. Swanigan's probably the best post player here. And the rest of the West looks like this. Malachi Richardson is the only Syracuse Orange in this game, and then Jalen Brunson is on his way to Villanova. His dad, Rick, was an All-American in this game back in 1991.
In relation to Ben Simmons, you know you're big time when ESPN holds off the tip to do an interview with you before the game even starts.
This is P.J. Dozier trying to help build up South Carolina's recruiting class for Frank Martin. Going down to Caleb Swanigan, who is undeclared. A lot of very good bigs in this game that we'll see. Here's the number one player. He's positionless. He can do everything. And he kicks to Blakeney, his future LSU Tiger teammate.
Eight players in this game are undeclared, and a lot of people are still waiting for to see what happens with Kentucky. Some teams still in the Final Four. People jockeying for position, seeing who's going to decide to declare early for the draft.
Little step back, Malik Newman pushing off of Blakeney.
You see two air balls early, sweaty palms, a lot of nerves, sure. Big crowd, NBA arena. The players will settle in. As you see the missed layup right there.
Isaiah Briscoe on his way to Kentucky. Here's the push. Dozier to Ivan Rabb, who is also undeclared out of Oakland, California. We'll see a lot of pace, a lot of high octane, a lot of energy, some nervous energy, but we're going to get a chance to see all of it tonight.
Ivan Rabb, a special talent as well, considering thinking about going to Arizona and Cal, the two teams on his list. Arizona today, some interesting news. Rondae Hollis-Jefferson decided to leave early for the draft. Opens up for a spot for a guy like Ivan Rabb.
Brandon Ingram, also undeclared, out of Kinston, North Carolina, number 12 player in the country. Makes it 4-0 in favor of the West. Briscoe, part of the number one recruiting class in the nation, will draw the foul. Briscoe, number 13 player in the country, going to Kentucky. Little alley-oop action early. P.J. Dozier running the floor.
And that's the key when you play in an all-star game. Get as many layups and dunks as possible. Then before you know it, the open jump shot is something that you can knock down.
Kentucky again, the number one recruiting class. The rich continue to get richer. Scal Labissiere is a top five player. He's going to Kentucky. And then Charles Matthews, a very good shooting guard. And of course, with all the undeclareds that we have in this game, a lot of them have Kentucky on the list.
It's amazing when you look at the list for all these players. Jaylen Brown, Kentucky's on his list. Malik Newman, Ivan Rabb, Chuck Diallo, Caleb Swanigan, Stephen Zimmerman,
yep.
Brandon Ingram. I mean, a lot of these players, almost essentially, it's like, it's just a free agency.
How much are they waiting to see what happens with the rest of the Kentucky lineup as Dozier hits a three?
If Kentucky wins the national championship, essentially John Calipari has painted Mona Lisa. It's difficult to tell any of those guys not to leave.
Sure.
How can it get any better for you?
In college, yeah.
Exactly, it can't.
And also, for all Cal critics, newsflash, the toughest thing to do in collegiate basketball is to recruit.
Yes.
Not only has he been able to do it, but he's had all of the guys buy into a team concept, has the opportunity to go undefeated and win the championship.
Diamond Stone, the most recent committee, is going to Maryland with a block. Another block at the other end as Blakeney was stuffed at the rim. And here comes the West with the long Brandon Ingram, a guy who can get to the bucket at will.
And I think you see a little more defense out here as you see the block up top, because remember in the scrimmage yesterday, it was a 30-point deficit.
Yeah, it was a blowout.
The West dominated the East yesterday.
Ingram trying to take it to the rim, and Diamond Stone will pick up the foul. Brandon Ingram is undeclared. Malik Newman is undeclared. Rabb, Zimmerman, Swanigan, some of the great players, all of them in the top 25 in terms of overall rankings. And a lot of things can happen. A lot of recruiting classes can change, and a lot of decisions can be made based on what these guys do, too.
Kentucky still with the number one recruiting class with only three players, and you have to think, you know, we were talking about this before the game, Jay. For the Harrison twins, I don't know if their stock can get any better than the way they've been playing this year. I mean, if you were still talking about them potentially the end of the first round, early second round, you have to think that, you know, Karl-Anthony Towns is going to be probably the first or second pick taken in the draft. I mean, Devin Booker is talking about him being a top 20 pick. I don't know if Ulis is thinking about leaving, but I mean, you have a lot of guys in that team that are going to be projected first round picks. Willie Cauley-Stein might be the sleeper out of all of them.
Sure.
A Tyson Chandler-like player.
Here is Swanigan, probably the best low post player overall in this game, according to Paul Biancardi. Good effort by Ivan Rabb to get the rebound and put the West back up by 7.
You see Simmons at 6'10", coast to coast with the float on.
Number one player in the class, McDonald's player of the year, Naismith player of the year, Gatorade player of the year. However, Antonio Blakeney got Florida Mr. Basketball over his future teammate Ben Simmons. As Ingram misses, it'll go the other way.
Well, Blakeney committed to Louisville, then decommitted earlier in the year to play with Ben Simmons. Each of these guys are in the same AAU team, each one teach one. Well, I mean, Ben Simmons right here, he's going to need to do a lot of this next year for Johnny Jones at LSU. Jordan Mickey is no longer around. Jarrell Martin, both these guys declared for the draft. It will be the Ben Simmons show next year.
Brown misses. Stone knocked it out. It belongs to the West.
And for a guy like Antonio Blakeney, that's as a guard, that's my dream. I can have my big man rebound the ball and push the ball up the court and have the versatility with his vision to find me as a spot-up shooter. I mean, you can only imagine him and Antonio Blakeney involved in pick and rolls.
Well, that's where the game has gone, having multiple players, 1 through 4 for a lot of teams, being able to advance the basketball and make a play with it.
Briscoe out of traffic, finding Blakeney.
That whole play started with Diamond Stone. Diamond Stone is so active defensively. Yesterday, he was battling people in practice. Mark Turgeon with a big-time recruit. With Melo Trimbo coming back.
Yep.
Jake Lehman being back in the picture. Maryland is actually going to be a team that can win the Big Ten next year. They also got Robert Carter, the transfer from Georgia Tech.
They got maybe the best front court in the Big Ten, yes, as of right now. Is to put in by Antonio Blakeney.
And Diamond Stone is like a 6'10 Kevin Hart. He's always playing some kind of practical joke on somebody. A kid has a great personality.
Somebody really loves you if they name you Diamond.
Yeah.
Good look by Ingram looking for Rab. Make that Dozier looking for Rab. And that'll take us to a timeout of the stay at this end of the floor. As we expect, a little bit of nerves to start. Now the offense starting to get going. 24 points on the board. And Diamond Stone is getting involved, getting the break going. And right now it's a 4-point West lead.
The 2015 McDonald's All-American Game is brought to you by McDonald's.
Starting to become very nice weather here in Chicago, Illinois. 4-point lead early for the West. For those of you watching this game with your phones and your tablets and your laptops, if you're watching, feel free to ask Jay Williams some questions that you want to hear from some of the players around this McDonald's All-American game. You can tweet at RealJayWilliams. Use the hashtag MCDAAG. Isaiah Briscoe is the only Kentucky commit in this game. He is with Jay Williams.
With Isaiah right now. Isaiah. We always know at these games there's some insider recruiting going on here. So out of the 8 undeclared players, who would you like to play with the most next year at Kentucky?
Out of the 8, I have to say Jaylen Brown.
Jaylen Brown. So you're trying to work on Jaylen Brown. Who else?
Jaylen Brown, Malik Newman. You know, he's a great player also. I just need somebody on the wing to catch and shoot.
So, all right. So we got a lot of work left to do. Okay, so what made you choose John Calipari over all the other coaches that recruited you?
You know what, Jay? Growing up, watching Kentucky, you know, seeing what he did at Memphis, Tyreek Evans and Kentucky, Derrick Rose and, you know, John Wall and Eric Bledsoe, and just the mold of guards and how he just let them play. And I just think that I can see myself playing at Kentucky. You know, that's the highest stage of college basketball, and that's just something I couldn't say no to.
Does that pressure scare you a little bit?
Pressure's not my vocabulary.
I like that. Well, yeah. There you go, Isaiah Briscoe. No pressure at all. He still thinks he's the best guard from New Jersey. I don't know about that. We still have a debate going on.
Roselle Catholic, my man. Roselle, New Jersey.
Coach Cal only has one McDonald's All-American. Fire that guy.
Shut it down. Shut it down. Nice kick by Jalen Brunson looking for Deonta Davis, who's on his way to Michigan State. Sheck Diallo with the rebound. Luke Kennard going to Duke. Great pure shooter. Juwan Evans going to Oklahoma State. He's from Dallas. He gets the step. And with the right hand trying to flip it, it's going to be basket interference anyway on the high-flying Thomas Bryant.
You mentioned Davis, one of the best players not many people are talking about. The future Spartan.
Yeah, another Michigan guy who's right up there in terms of numbers that he put up with Jalen Rose, another Michigan guy. Malachi Richardson flipping to the corner for Jalen Brunson on a three. There is Davis, the aforementioned future Spartan, to Richardson, who couldn't get the friendly bounce. This is Juwan Evans. Dwayne Bacon, number 4 in black. You want to watch Dwayne Bacon. He's on his way to Florida State. He's been one of the most dynamic players all week long. Sheck Diallo misses, and here's the undeclared big with the rebound. Zimmerman. And a steal by Diallo. He's got the best motor of anybody in this game. Took more steps than anybody in this game and got the left-handed layup down.
I love his motor, the way he competes offensively, defensively, going after boards, helping the helper, contesting shots.
I love this matchup between Jalen Brunson and Juwan Evans.
Yeah.
Juwan Evans, one of the purest point guards in this class, going to play for Travis Ford at Oklahoma State.
And there's the highest flyer that we've seen this week. Dwayne Bacon is going to Florida State. I'm telling you right now, that's a top 25 team. Monte Brandon, Xavier Rattan-Mays, and this guy in their backcourt, plus 3 7-footers again next year.
Watching Dwayne Bacon, I think if he were, players were able to leave out of high school to go into the NBA draft, I think he would be a top 10 NBA draft pick.
Paul Biancardi says he's a two-guard of the NBA waiting to happen. Alonzo Trier, the future Arizona Wildcat, knocks down the third West 3. Let's go over to Quinn Kesting.
Joined by Brandon Ingram, one of 8 undecideds in this ballgame. You list 6 schools on your list. How much are you tuned right now into what's going on in terms of guys leaving early or staying?
That's a very big factor for me right now. People leaving for the NBA draft and seeing who's coming back.
Who here on this McDonald's roster has been doing the best sell job?
Uh, has to be between Carlton Bragg and Chase Jeter.
Is it tough? You're from North Carolina. Is it tough to maybe think out of state, or is the local pressure intense?
Local pressure is kind of intense, but I'm just looking for the best fit for myself.
Any kind of time frame?
I want to make a decision by the end of this month.
Excellent. Thank you, Brandon.
Local pressure. You know, you think about in Kinston, one of the top players, a lot of other great North Carolina players that came from Kinston as well, one including his AAU coach and Jerry Stackhouse.
You know what I love, and I'm looking at Jaylen Brown's list of schools. He has 10 of them.
You're not a fan of that, I know, Jaylen. I can understand
why.
Well,
it's not a surprise for Jaylen to be undecided. But 10 schools?
Hey, you know what I'm going to say about it, though? I do like the fact you don't need to rush this decision.
Sure.
You could take your time.
It's an important decision.
You should fill out all your options. Yeah. You know, go on your recruiting trips. Get wine and dine. You know what I mean? Get told what you can do and find the right fit. I shouldn't say wine and dine.
That's the three of us after this game tonight. Well, if you're a fan of the triple-double, if you want to know how the West is going to be won, these are your games. Oklahoma City takes on Memphis. Portland will take on Los Angeles. It's NBA Friday presented by State Farm. Starts with Kia NBA Countdown. What do we expect, Jaylen, with those two games, by the way, as Evans takes it in and misses?
Playoff positioning in the Western Conference. Teams jockeying. The West playoff race is going to be awesome. Don't miss it.
Zimmerman, one of the best undeclared bigs, misses. There is Davis, who had 199 shot blocks last year to set a new Michigan record. Maybe one of the biggest recruits out of that state, out of that area in Muskegon in a decade.
Nice fundamentals. Got the offensive rebound, kept the basketball high, soft touch, easy too.
Thomas Bryant throws it down.
Chet Diallo is so special, so talented. His versatility, once again, you know, you're seeing a lot of these players who are 6'8", 6'9", who possess the talent to handle the basketball and make plays in traffic. Not only can he finish, and he's an intimidating shot blocker, but he has a vision to find people in traffic as well.
Alonzo Trier flipping it back up and in, the only Arizona Wildcat commit in this game. But Sean Miller has another great recruiting class coming in next year.
But that's the beauty of basketball, Jay. Every 6'11 power forward has once been a 6'1 point guard.
Yes.
Always work on your entire package.
But I do like the old-fashioned center, too, like Diamond Stone. He's a center, legit old-school center.
He's going to be a part of a very, very good Maryland team next year. A lot of these guys are going to be part of very good programs next season, including the number one player in the country, Ben Simmons. More from the Shy when you come back. Some of the great memories and some of the great players that have been through the McDonald's All-American game. This is pretty decent.
The big ticket. Three,
two, little four. Paul Pierce action.
Paul Pierce had a hot top curl.
Vince Carter, one of the nastiest dunkers ever, got his start.
Vincent Lamar hot top.
Great stuff, man. The most all-time in terms of McDonald's All-Americans, UNC, with 65 of them. Duke is right there with 60. There's Michael Jordan's jersey here in the rafters at the United Center. No surprise, those are the blue blood programs that we think of more often than not. Recruiting is the lifeblood. It's the foundation. It's the basis for what ends up happening for programs and teams as we work forward the next several years with these guys.
Embrace the past. Prepare for the future.
Here is Chase Jeter, future Duke Blue Devil. It's rebounded by Isaiah Briscoe. Good Simmons, pass. Beautiful pass to Stone. That's what we're talking about, the vision of Ben Simmons, the best passer in the class.
I saw the exact same trait in this game last year with D'Angelo Russell.
Yeah.
Passing players open, anticipating, giving the basketball up early, seeing a play ahead. That's an innate skill.
At 6'9", he's the best passer in this class. A positionless player, Ben Simmons. He can play any position. Chase Jeter, tight to the rim. Lab, doing what he's been doing all first half, cleaning up the glass. Out of Oakland, CA.
Normally the bigs and the effort players are more efficient in games like this, getting those cleanups, getting those drop-off dunks, jump hooks, and post-ups.
And something we've seen, 8 of the top 10 players in the rankings are bigs, power forwards and centers, and they all have a variety of skill sets. That's where the game's kind of going. You said it.
Absolutely.
There is Brown flipping it in. His first two. Undeclared out of Alpharetta, Georgia.
Under control. Nice touch. Finish off the backboard.
It's a traveling violation against Malik Newman. Let's get to know a little bit about the number two player in the country. Kansas and Kentucky are at the top of the list. UCLA, North Carolina, Michigan. He's been on visits there. He'll slot into small forward maybe if he goes to Kansas or Kentucky. Obviously, we don't know exactly who's staying, who's going, but if he goes to one of those two schools, he's going to have a slot more than likely right off the top.
What can Brown do for you? He'll be a starter next year.
Yeah. Wherever he goes.
He reminds me very much of Stanley Johnson, who plays for Arizona right now, that same kind of build. I think offensively he might be a little bit more gifted.
Okay.
But there's no doubt about it. You can only imagine Jaylen Brown on the next level. He's a prototypical two guard. He can lock down other two guards in the league at 6'7".
And he does something I still haven't figured out how to do. Play defense.
Yeah.
This guy was picking up.
You were one of the worst. I was a bad defender, but
this guy was picking up 94 feet in a scrimmage. Don't be the type of players that you just hate to go against. Like, just get off me.
I think yesterday he was trying to make a statement. And we talk about that all the time. Some players look at it, we talking about practice. We're talking about practice. But Jaylen Brown didn't take on that mentality yesterday. Right. He came in here along with Ben Simmons, and they showed everybody this is why they have us labeled number one and number two in the country.
Briscoe gets called for that foul. Thursday night, a lot of exciting college hoops action. We'll have the 2015 State Farm College Slam Dunk and three-point championships leading you in to Stanford and Miami for the NIT Championship from Madison Square Garden on ESPN and Watch ESPN. Very exciting games last night in the semifinals as Temple gave Miami a run. Old Dominion came all the way back to make it a close game against Stanford.
And we're going to take one of these Twitter questions real quick. At 34 Rhodes, giving you a shout-out. Hey, Real Jay Williams, do you think LSU will make a major impact next year? I think they will with Antonio Blakeney and Ben Simmons. There's no doubt about it. Now, their front line will be a little bit limited considering they lose Mickey and Martin. But when you got the number one player in the country coming to your school, and you have some good wing players, Keith Hornsby, Josh Gray, Tim Quarterman, they have guards. It's going to lack at the post position, but they can definitely be a top team in the SEC.
We'll talk with Antonio Blakeney on the other side of the break when we get to the media timeout, too. Briscoe step back smooth.
Isaiah Briscoe.
He's ties it back up at 25. Yeah, LSU's got the number six recruiting class in the country. The SEC has a half dozen teams in the top 25 of the recruiting rankings right now, led by Kentucky at the top.
Isaiah Briscoe, just a big combo guard. Physically just gifted, overpowers people, coached by the New Jersey players. Good old Jimmy Salmons, the head coach.
Jaylen Brown puts it in. He'll go to the line. Look at the LSU commits. The highest ranked commits, three of them since 2007, have come in the last 2 years. Jarrell Martin, who declared for the NBA draft along with Jordan Mickey, and then you have both Blakeney and Simmons on that list. So Johnny Jones making his mark now on the recruiting trail.
Well, Ben Simmons' father played in Australia, played overseas basketball.
Dave.
One of his really good friends is now the assistant coach at LSU. So smart move by Johnny Jones. You got to do what you got to do in order to get top recruits in your school.
That's David Patrick. He's the godfather of Ben Simmons, who picks up the steal. Watch him in the open floor. Well, he got into traffic and still was able to keep it alive. He's so fast. I think that's what stuck out, even though the play kind of broke down. His quickness was insane. Blakeney misses. Simmons there with the tap. And then a foul is called with 8:12 to play. This is the key losses for LSU. There they are. Mickey and Martin going to the NBA. Ben Simmons, Antonio Blakeney could fit right in. It's going to be a little bit more guard heavy in terms of what LSU is going to have next year.
There's some interesting names that have been entering the draft. I mean, you have Michael Frazier entering the draft from Florida. I don't really know about that. I don't know his situation. I don't know any of these guys' situations.
Sure.
But, you know, you question some of these decisions about kids leaving early.
And the decision ends up being, do you want to get drafted or do you want to have a long career?
Sure.
We came along in the era where we worked out. These guys trained. And so college has become a really good incubator for NBA talent. If you don't feel like in any way, shape, or form that your draft position is something that you're proud of, it's okay to stay in school, get that season, and become a better basketball player. Coach Cal, this is basically his invitational game. He even said his players aren't ready after 1 year.
Right.
And he has some of the top players in the league right now.
Kentucky's going to go up against some very good recruits next year in the SEC and LSU. Get to know Antonio Blakeney, the number 14 player in the country out of Sarasota, Florida. The Mr. Basketball Award winner, over his buddy Ben Simmons. We'll talk with him on the other side. Only Duke and LSU have multiple commits in this game. We'll talk with one of them next. Six players from the McDonald's All-American game are going to be on a plane tomorrow headed to New York because they're getting set for the Dix High School Nationals, including Ben Simmons and his Montvert Academy team trying to win the title. It'll be the Dix Sporting Goods High School Nationals tomorrow at noon, starting off on ESPNU with coverage all weekend long. Adam, Jay, Jalen are here. Quint Kasnick is over there somewhere. Where are you at, Quint?
I'm on the bench with Antonio Blakeney, who's headed to LSU. First of all, you're from Florida. Ben Simmons is from Florida. How do you win Mr. Basketball in Florida over Ben?
I mean, I don't know. I mean, Ben obviously didn't play a lot of games in Florida, so that could have weighed into it. But, you know, I had a great season, and he had a great season, so it could have went either way.
The standard of excellence and expectations will rise at LSU with you and Ben. Why was that appealing?
It was very appealing because, you know, I'm different. I want to be a trendsetter. I don't want to do the same thing everybody else is doing. You know, I want to start a tradition.
So you had options to play at some big-time name programs, obviously, but you chose your own path.
Yes. Just like I said, I want to be able to start something on my own. You know, me and Ben can start something the next year. You know, other good players come in. But Coach Johnny Jones, the last 3 years that he's been there, he's had good players. So we're not the first one. We just keep adding on.
What's the dream?
What's my dream?
Yeah, what's the dream at LSU?
Oh, it's, of course, win the SEC championship and make a run in the tournament.
What do you have to do to get the team there?
I mean, I just have to work hard, you know, listen to my coaches and lead the team.
Thanks, Antonio. Adam?
Quint, thanks very much.
I'm different. Yeah, I'm different. I like that.
He sounded a little bit like him.
I like that. You know,
it was smooth.
It does take a unique kid to blaze their own path at a school like LSU. And Ben Simmons and him had a chance to do that. But not too soon. Not too soon, because Kentucky still have a great class, and Texas A&M has a top five recruiting class as well.
They're number three, as a matter of fact. Believe it or not, Texas A&M is the number three recruiting class in the country. The SEC wasn't this strong when you were going into college. I know Arkansas was good. They were en route to a title, but the rest of the SEC wasn't up to par. They might be getting there now.
It starts with the hiring of Coach Cal. Everybody got to catch up. He set the bar a lot higher. And how did he do it? So there are other schools that recruit what we consider the quote-unquote one-and-done players. So why does Cal get the label? It's because he owned it from the beginning.
Yeah.
While teams were selling going for 4 years and graduating, he was selling, if you listen to what I say, you could be in the NBA draft, take care of your family, and make millions of dollars.
Yep.
I like the way that sounds.
Alonzo Trier at one end for the Arizona Wildcats. Look at this play. Very smooth handles against Luke Kennard. But
a big time block.
Sheck Diallo did it at both ends. We talked about the motor. Jalen's already talked about the motor. Diallo, the block at one end, the finish at the other, leading to a timeout. And take a look at the SEC teams. Kentucky, A&M, LSU, Florida, and then two more teams, including Arkansas, in the top 25.
And give Marquette, give Seymour Dowski some credit after 1 year in the Big East. They have a top 10 recruiting class as well, obviously led by McDonald's All-American Henry Ellison here. But, you know, back to your original point about Cal, Jalen, you know, he has such a way about him. First off, he's a player's coach. And let me tell you how he does it, too. So Malik Newman goes for his unofficial visit, right? He's down there summertime hanging out, seeing Cal, seeing the team. By the way, Cal has a fantasy camp, all right, where he has about 15,000 to 20,000 people that come in to see a lot of his former players come back and play in a game, in an all-star game. All right, so Malik Newman's down there, and he gets a chance to meet Drake. He gets a chance to meet John Wall. He gets a chance to meet Derrick Rose. How can you sell your program better than seeing these all-stars right then and there?
John distinguished himself by basically showing that those other guys are dinosaurs. I know about social media. I know what it takes to get you to the next level, and he embraced it and he owned it.
I was appreciated Drake's basketball career, I think, more than most of. 13 to
Georgia State, baby. Georgia State.
That's right.
Ron Hunter. RJ Hunter committed for the draft, too.
That's right.
He's going to be a pro. I'll tell you, that kid's good.
Trier puts it in. He's got seven plus the foul. Remember Ron Hunter from my Valpo days. He was an IUPUI head coach. Always energetic there, too. Nice start to the game for Trier going to Arizona.
And Trier just strong, overpowering his opponents. And I love the fact he can put his head down and get anywhere he wants on the court. You know, I was doing some research because we got the Final Four coming up next week.
Yeah.
A total of 18 McDonald's All-Americans are participating in the Final Four. A combined 17 play for Duke and Kentucky. The only other McDonald's All-American not on Duke and Kentucky, Brendan Dawson from Michigan State. There is not one McDonald's All-American on Wisconsin's team.
You know, I love
to hear college coaches complain about the rosters that they recruit.
Here's Trier dumping it off underneath for Bragg, who's the lone Kansas commit in this game. He'll go to the free throw line. And this is what Arizona's class looks like. Sean Miller doing another great job. And think about some of the size that they already have. Now you're going to get a little backcourt help when you need it the most.
Well, you know, you think you're going to lose Stanley Johnson. He's probably going to be a top 10 pick. Rondae Hollis-Jefferson declared. TJ McConnell, he's a senior. But you think about what this team Ashley comes back, Caleb Tarzewski comes back, Kadeem Allen, who transferred in, he's playing. I mean, with this recruiting class, Arizona's going to be right back up there again. It's not going to be too long before Sean Miller gets to the Final Four.
Here's Dedrick Lawson, the Memphis Tiger commit, taking a deep two. Kennard tried to save it, and it'll go the other way. 5:05 to play first half. The East with a six-point lead. It's been a nice back-and-forth affair so far. This is Jalen Brunson. His dad, Rick, was the MVP of the 91 All-American game. Ended up playing a season for the Bulls with the two guys sitting next to me, that 0-2-0-3 team. Jay Williams, Jalen Rose, Ricky Brunson, Marcus Fizer, and Jalen taking it all the way to the rack.
And that's why Jalen, I think, might be a little bit better than his dad. He can use the right hand, Jay.
His dad can't do anything with his right hand at all. The best pure point guard we have in this game. Always seems to be under control. Look, head up, under control, scanning the floor.
Think about where he's going, too. You talk about a point guard's dream to play for Jay Wright at Villanova. Gets a chance next year to play alongside of Ryan Arcidiacono. That's going to be another big-time time.
Oh, Steven Zimmerman with the left-hand hammer. He just threw it down right in the defender's face on the feed from Richardson. And a steal out high by Bragg. Showtime in Chi-Town. Get up, Lawrence, Kansas for Carlton Bragg. Tie game at 36. A spectacular 6-0 run, Jalen.
And Jay, you mentioned Duke and UK, the number of players they have in the Final Four. But a couple of other programs quietly always recruit a few McDonald's All-Americans. Arizona and Kansas seem to come to mind. They always find a way to still be in living rooms.
Carlton Bragg next year playing alongside Perry Ellis. Probably going to be, you know, Kelly Oubre.
You think Kelly goes?
He declared.
He did. That's right.
You wonder about Cliff Alexander, but Carlton Bragg, another guy that can be a stretch four, can space, you know, face you up, space out the defense with that jump shooting ability, and also has low post moves, very similar to Perry Ellis.
Last touch by Bragg, but he's made a nice little impact. Speaking of high impact at this end of the floor,
call for impact. Boom! Get up for the get down. Chi-Town, we in the mix.
Let's get to know one of our undeclared players. Not from Harlem or Hollywood, he's from Jackson, Mississippi. Malik Newman with Kansas and Kentucky and LSU and Mississippi State with the new head coach Ben Howland in the mix, maybe NC State or Ole Miss. Said he wants to take his time with his decision. I'm sure Jay Williams is going to try to poke and prod with him right now.
All right, Malik, first question I have for you comes from a guy on Twitter, Mizzy Moose. He wants to know, are you the best guard to come out of Jackson? You talk about Mo Williams, Monte Ellis, Lindsey Hunter. Are you the best guard to come out of Jackson, Mississippi?
Yeah, I think I am.
All right, next question. Your father played at Mississippi State. Obviously, Ben Howland, just a new coach there. Does that influence your decision at all?
No, not a lot at all.
All right, there you go. Malik Newman, good luck out there.
Tight lip, Jay. I knew you were going to go investigative journalist on him, but naturally tight-lipped Malik Newman, understandably so as well.
I appreciate his innocence. If I was 6'3", 175, and averaging 31 points per game, my favorite TV show wouldn't be SpongeBob.
Naivete, innocence, youthful exuberance, Jalen.
I love it. I was watching Good Times in Sanford and Son.
No 227 on that mention. A little disappointed. This is the number one player in the country, Ben Simmons. Originally from Melbourne, Australia, moved to Florida in 2013. He's playing for Montverde Academy. You'll see him during the Dix High School Nationals this week. And Diamond Stone on his way to Maryland, the latest commit. Melo Trimble said today for sure that he's coming back. And Diamond Stone said if Melo wasn't coming back, he may not go to Maryland.
I'm a fan of Thomas Bryant and Diamond Stone. Bigs down low, traditional, stepping out, still making the open jump shots.
Ingram with a one-handed rebound. Got it maybe deterred by Simmons, and then he stayed on the glass. Brandon Ingram out of Kingston, North Carolina, undeclared, doing it big here in this first half.
Looked like a slinky the way he jumped up there, grabbed that offensive board, and put it back in.
Brown took a spill. A
first
foul.
Down and 10.
Caleb Swanigan on the foul. Talk about the women's Final Four getting going. It is all number one seeds. Dawn Staley made it as a player in the early 90s. Now as a coach, she leads South Carolina against Notre Dame. And then Maryland and UConn. We saw three of those four teams represented in the girls' All-American game today. The Final Four from Tampa begins on Sunday on ESPN.
Jay, have we lost the madness all chalk in the ladies' Final Four?
It's almost
three of the four teams in the men's are number one seeds.
7-1 seeds.
And this is the year we were talking about parity exists in college basketball. Three number one seeds.
What's wrong with the cream rising to the top, though, guys? As Brown, this is the free throw. And we go to Quint Kesnick with a guy who's got some hardware on the football field.
That's right. Ohio State, longtime NFL runner. Back Eddie George, you got a great seat, first of all. Yeah. How do you put in perspective the quality of athlete you're seeing here?
Oh, it's exceptional. These guys are built, they're young. I mean, you can see how explosive they are. This close up on the floor, it's amazing to see where they're going to be when they get in the program, get the weightlifting program underneath them. Just how far beyond they're going to be where they are right now. It's amazing.
Blakeney rejected by Ingram on that 3-on-1. What's the biggest challenge these guys are going to face between now and let's say start of the second semester around Christmas time next year?
I think just making the adjustment from high school to college, getting acclimated to the environment, having free time on their hands. But you know what? I think most of these guys are ready for the next level. I mean, you can see it athletically, but from a mental perspective, they have to really find some mentors, some older guys that can really take care of them, and hopefully they can make the transition easy for them.
How about number 25, Ben Simmons?
Oh, he's a man. I mean, number one player in the country. I'm looking at him like he could be a wide receiver, a hybrid tight end, outside linebacker. The same goes for Jaylen Brown. Tremendous athletes. I mean, they're so fast and explosive. It's incredible.
He's going to LSU, but not to play for Les Miles. Adam?
You know what? And Eddie George is absolutely right. Ben Simmons, he's got a really interesting background as an Australian rules football player and rugby player. No shock that Eddie George, a guy who knows what he's talking about, would say he could play on the football field. He gave those sports up at the age of 14 to really focus solely on basketball. It's been a pretty good run for him as well.
First off, every time I see Eddie George, it makes me want to go back and get in the weight room.
Get in the gym, right?
I need to start doing some push-ups or something. It looks like he's still playing.
Yeah, man. You see Ben Simmons, what he needs to work on, though, the shooting range and the rebounding, and I imagine, and I wonder if this was the case for you guys, you get stronger from freshman year to sophomore year, you're in a full year in the weight program, that might help him a little bit.
I appreciate the humility of these players, because Jay Williams was interviewing them yesterday, and a lot of the guys, the first thing they mentioned was their weaknesses.
Yeah.
Things that they need to work on. A lot of times in high school, you don't have a moral or social compass. You think?
Do you say that from experience, just out of curiosity?
I'm 100% speaking from experience. And so the maturity of these young players, I really appreciate it. In the era of social media,
yeah,
and so much scrutiny, having to always behave and make quality decisions and still be able to perform at a high level. And we talk about them being competitive. A lot of these guys compete in the classroom. A lot of honor roll students as well.
Dozier to Ingram.
And one of those questions I asked yesterday was to Dwayne Bacon, and I said, if you could leave early right now from high school and be a top 10 pick, would you go?
That's right.
And he said, no, I think I need to become a better defender, and that's why I'm going to go to Florida State. And it takes that kind of maturity. And look, if you actually got, first off, high school players should be able to leave out of high school and go to the NBA. We need to make some changes on that.
What a noble idea.
I mean, seriously, I mean, I understand really? We want to make the college game better. So if you go to college, maybe you can stay 2 or 3 years, but you should be able to go directly out of high school.
Do you like the baseball model where you go either go out of high school, or if you're going to go to college, you should commit for 2, maybe 3 years like it is in baseball?
All I know is some of the top players currently in the NBA came straight out of high school.
Sure.
Kobe Bryant, Kevin Garnett, it's been a successful tool for a lot of players, and I think you should have the opportunity.
Well, Emmanuel Mudiay, and I saw Jay Billis on ESPN before our game tonight talking about Emmanuel Mudiay, who's somebody
top five pick.
Who's going to be a top five pick, who played in this game last year. Obviously, that was a bit of a different issue with the academics and things like that, but when you can't figure everything out for your first year of college, or you know you're going to leave after a year, do you think some guys are going to start doing what Mudiay did? Well, go overseas, play a year, and then go to the
Brendan ground. Jennings did it before
Jennings
that.
Jennings did it for the Bucks. Yeah,
it's going to be a trend that I think we're going to continue to see, especially if the 2017 CBA comes up and Adam Silver decides to make it a two-year maximum, you know, two-year minimum in college. Minimum,
yeah. I just always struggled with the idea that basketball and football were the only sports that had age limits and restrictions. I struggle with that.
Yeah, it's an understandable thing to struggle with because it doesn't necessarily fit in with everything else. Brandon Ingram has had one of the best first halves of anybody on the floor tonight. He's got 13. Shot clock is off. Here is Simmons against Jeter.
We're going to get into that in the second half, but the fact that coaches are making millions of dollars. I mean, contracts aren't like they used to be back 20 years ago. I mean, guys are signing multiple million-dollar years for a shoe contract. The NCAA is making money. The players should be able to get a cut of it. They should. We'll talk about that in the second half.
Briscoe to Stone to close out half number one. We'll get to know the number one player in the country, Ben Simmons, during halftime. The players get to visit the Ronald McDonald House, the fine sponsor and charity that gets all of the proceeds for this game, and, of course, the best dunks from the Jam Fest. High motor guy. Sheck Diallo right now with Quint Kesching.
Yeah, talking about a hustler, Sheck, where does that engine come from within you?
I mean, that's a natural, like, because I used to play soccer when I was younger. That's kind of like I have a lot of energy and I'm fast too.
Are you aware that the teams that you're considering are watching this game?
I mean, I think so, yes.
Is that motivation?
Yes, motivation, yeah.
When do you expect to make a decision?
I mean, I'm waiting for like something like maybe April after Jordan game or before Jordan game.
You keep blocking shots. Your phone's going to be ringing off the hook. Adam.
Great first half. 8 points, 7 rebounds, couple blocks as well for Sheck Diallo, a native of Mali, who is going to make somebody very happy. Maybe Kentucky or Kansas or Iowa State or St. John's with new head coach Chris Mullin or Jamie Dixon at Pitt. High octane, a lot of scoring, 49-46. It's a lead for the East at the halftime break. We'll see some of the best dunks from the Jam Fest during the halftime. We'll get to know Ben Simmons. All that coming up after this 3-point one game from the show. Back in Chicago, halftime of the McDonald's Boys High School All-American Game. It's been a very interesting path from Australia to Florida to here in Chicago for the number one player in the country, Ben Simmons.
My path coming over to the States and being an All-American has been long, but to start it off, I came over here for a few camps, Adidas Nations 2012. I was just having fun with it, just playing, enjoying the game with my friends, and then, you know, coming to America and being on a highlight video, that was big enough for me, just being in like a 3-second clip of me dunking a ball, that was crazy. So from there, it just kind of took off. I wanted to, you know, play in America because the competition is a lot higher and the players are more athletic physically. So I think for me, it was just getting better and finding a way I could just improve my game. Well, my dad played professionally in Australia, Belgium, all over Europe. So he's a big basketball person. He's had all the experiences and he is from New York. So being American, I'm half American. And just living in Australia, I think he taught me the Australian side and the American side, how to play the games. The most common question I get is, do you have kangaroos in front of your backyard?
And what do you tell them?
Of course, nah. being Player of the Year is definitely an honor. There's so many guys at this event that are great players and who have played really well this season, but I've just been blessed enough that I was given the award, and I think it has a lot to do with my family, my parents, my teammates, and coach. Back home, I usually go back to my old primary school and go talk to them, so a lot of those guys that I was at school with, you know, are now teenagers, so it's good to go back there and just talk to them, tell them my experiences, all about being over in America and playing basketball. being a part of this event, it means a lot. Just being able to go to the Ronald McDonald's house and seeing, you know, I met a friend today, Bradley, so that was an eye-opener for me. It's just good to give back. I think for me, I know a lot of this stuff happens off the court. You know, being a good person is more important than being a good basketball player.
Some great stuff from Ben Simmons. We've had a lot of fun this week. Coming up, we'll see the top dunks from Monday night's Powerade Jam Fest. Beautiful night in Chicago. It's halftime of the McDonald's Boys High School All-American Game. It's been a great week. A lot of great events make up this week, including the Skills Camp. There's Mike Dunleavy, the current NBA star, former McDonald's All-American himself. He paid a visit this week as part of the McDonald's All-American Skills Clinic. This clinic engages kids and families from the community while promoting some fun and physical activity. A lot of tips on a variety of fundamentals, lessons on having a little fun, too. It's made for a great day of learning and development. Maybe an All-American of the future waiting in the midst during this skills clinic. And of course, one of the great events of the week is the Powerade Jam Fest. These are the top four dunks that people were voting on. Little Isaiah Briscoe to Dwayne Bacon with one hand. Dwayne Bacon, who won the contest, leaping over our man Jalen Rose. But the winner amongst the fans, the best dunk, belongs to Steven Zimmerman. He got a little bit of help from Jalen Brunson. The Let Me Take a Selfie dunk. Jalen was taking a Snapchat video of himself getting dunked on by Steven Zimmerman. Awesome, awesome stuff. We'll have highlights of the first half for the boys' game coming up after this. Back to the 2015 McDonald's All-American Game from Chicago, Illinois. Fifth straight year we're here. The game has been played every year since 78 when it was played in Philadelphia to start it off. Ben Simmons is the number one player in the country. He had 5 points and he had 7 rebounds in the first half. The East with a 3-point lead. Back courtside, Adam Amin, Jay Will, Jay Rose. Two of the three were McDonald's All-Americans. You get to guess who. Opening thoughts from the first 20 minutes, guys. Let's start with you, Jay.
I like it. It's a competitive game. Yeah. I mean, yesterday, I was a little bit disappointed when we walked away from the scrimmage because the West blew off East by about 30 points.
That's unacceptable. I agree.
And I like the fact that these kids now are buckling down with the lights on.
I like what I've seen from Brandon Ingram in the first half. I know we're going to talk a lot about Jaylen Brown and a lot about Ben Simmons, but 13 points in 13 minutes. Being really aggressive.
This is what we're taking a look at, Brandon Ingram, Jalen.
And at 6'8", 190, I like the fact one of his hidden talents, skateboarding, which tells you that he's good with his feet and with his balance. As you see him act up down low with the offensive board, again using the left hand with the finish around the hoop.
And then Isaiah Briscoe, a physical combo guard. He really is built ahead of his peers maturity-wise physically. And when you have mentors in your life like Kyrie Irving from St. Patrick's, like Carmelo Anthony who plays for the Knicks, like J.R. Smith who now plays for Cleveland, you're probably on your way to doing some pretty good things in your life.
Briscoe and Ingram are highlighted. Diamond Stone just looking over at Jay Williams. I'm sure he's going to want to talk to you at some point, Jay. 8 points in the first half. I love Sheck Diallo's motor. 8.7 boards, couple blocks. Trier is going to Arizona. Ivan Rabb is undeclared. We mentioned Isaiah Briscoe. Let's send it over to Quint Kestnick. He's with him right now.
Look at these stats. 9 points, 4 rebounds, 2 assists in only 11 minutes. What was the last time you played 11 minutes and a half?
I can't even remember, honestly. But you know what? I'm just so blessed for the opportunity. You know, I want to thank McDonald's and everybody for just giving me this wonderful experience.
You do the math, you're going to have a heck of a game. What's the mindset?
To win first, you know, I might try to get a triple double.
I like your attitude, and I like the smile. You always play with that big smile.
Well, you know, playing basketball is something I love to do. I love to have fun. I love to compete. So, you know, I'm enjoying myself.
How'd you get to the line so well?
That's my bread and butter. That's my bread and butter. You know, that's where I got my points from.
Keep it rolling, Isaiah.
Appreciate it.
Adam.
Thanks very much. Isaiah Briscoe, 5 of 6 at the line with 4 rebounds and a couple of assists as well.
You know, last year he had a foot injury, so he wasn't able to play for a long stretch. And I still think the conditioning for Isaiah Briscoe is something that needs to get better. But when you look at him, he has all the physical tools to be a legitimate pro. I mean, at 6'4", 6'5", He's strong enough. He has the height. He can see over the top of the defense. And he can really score the basketball. And he's really good, Jalen. As we both know, in order to be successful in the NBA, you have to have a high basketball IQ and understand how to be involved in a pick and roll. And he can do that.
And a physical presence. You could tell he's skill-wise working on his game, but he's not missing any workouts in the weight room.
I got a question for you guys because you just brought it up, and I am curious about it. With guys that are, we're talking about the NBA. I'm sure a lot of people are going, these guys are 18. Why are we talking about that? They still have college to go. But there are guys that are playing in the league right now that were in this game 2 years ago. A lot of these guys have thoughts of going to the NBA. You see a lot of one-and-dones from this game, play the year in college, go to the NBA. We can talk about the structure later, but just in terms of talent, that's why we're talking about this. There's a reason why NBA scouts are here tonight watching 24 guys.
Absolutely, and some may deem it a blanket statement, but in 2013, of the 24 players, I should say only five are in the NBA right now. Wiggins, Jabari, Aaron Gordon, Vonleh, and Julius Randle. That's slim pickings.
You just saw John Paxson in that shot a moment ago as well. He's one of the GMs that's here today.
You know what I appreciate about Pax being a GM of the Bulls? He's done a really good job building that roster. Hopefully his team can get healthy and make a run in the Eastern Conference playoffs. I was walking through the hallway and they have some pictures of some of the best Bulls players ever. And I counted, it was 10 of them up. He had his cell phone. I appreciated that.
Wouldn't you have your
Jalen
shout
definitely
out?
Put a picture of himself.
He might have the shrine.
That's why I paid attention to it.
I'm actually going to put one of these photos of Jalen Rose that I have and actually put it on the face of the Jordan statue when we get out of here.
You know, a lot of fans out there ask these questions. So how can these guys be considered, you know, top 10 NBA draft picks? Because GMs look at it from a potential perspective. Potential. You know, last year, one of the players we didn't talk about at this game as much because we focused on the likes of Jahlil Okafor and some other players. We didn't talk about Karl Anthony Towns a lot last year. We didn't talk about him at all, really. And he's a guy right now, you talk about potential, and he could be the first pick taken in the NBA draft.
We were talking about D'Angelo Russell. We didn't get talk a ton about it. I wasn't here, but I watched the game. You guys didn't necessarily talk a ton about Russell. He ended up being one of the best guards in the country.
That's the beauty of sports. And right now, there are at least 50 guys at home watching this game that feel like politics is the reason that they're not here. So just because you're not playing in this game, that doesn't obviously mean you don't have what it takes to be a productive player at the next level and even take it a step further to the NBA. So stay motivated if you're at home watching this game.
By the way, I mean, so that's exactly what you're talking about when you think about Frank Kaminsky or Sam Decker or Nigel Hayes.
Yep.
The entire front line for the team that's in the Final Four, and none of those guys were McDonald's All-American.
Paul Biancardi made a great point to me when we were talking with him early in the week, said, hey, some three-star guys turn into five-star college players. Some five-star college players play like three-star college players. You're hoping that Carlton Bragg's got something to do with it at Kansas.
But it starts by taking it personal. Right now, you should be watching this game fuming, smoke coming out of your ears, doing push-ups between the commercial breaks. Understanding you're going to get your chance to compete against these players.
That's what I was doing, actually, during the commercial break. Brunson on the push. He's a pure point guard.
You need to do
guard.
A lot more.
I'm trying to get to Eddie George level. 3% body fat. Jay Williams claimed on air yesterday that he had 3%.
I didn't claim that. The player claimed it for me.
You didn't deny it, my man.
Of course I didn't deny it.
Trier gets fouled by Sheck Diallo. He'll go to the free throw line. Still love the motor for the center each New York native, Sheck Diallo, the native of Mali. Trier going hard to the rack. You got to appreciate that aggressiveness for the future Arizona Wildcat.
One of the things that all these young players are going to learn, especially when they get to the collegiate level, but even more so in the NBA level, a lot of players love to go to the basket and try to finish over bigs. You start going up in levels, you better start to develop. All those young players at home right now, develop a floater in your repertoire because you're going to need that offensively. You're not going to be able to overpower some of the bigs that are going to be on the next level.
Absolutely. That giant killer off 2 feet, that floater or that runner off 1 foot all day. I remember in the 90s, that was considered a bad shot.
Kim English kind of got it going. Derrick Rose does it a lot here in Chicago, especially with the lack of explosiveness we've seen the last few years. Hey, we were talking about Jalen Brunson, great pure point guard. His dad played played with you guys. He was an MVP of this game. He's here. He's with Quinn Kestick, as a matter of fact.
Yeah, played in this game back in 1991. What is more anxious, playing in this game or watching Jalen play?
Playing is easy because, you know, you can control it. Right now, I'm just a dad having fun, but I get nervous watching my son play.
Monday night at Jam Fest, you could sense your son's toughness and focus, and he said a lot of that comes from you.
Nah, that comes from his mother. He gave me too much credit. He does a great job. You know, he's a great individual. He works hard, and we're just proud of him.
He had a lot of options. Why Villanova?
You know, it was my son's decision. He wanted to go to a place where he could fit in and have a coach that believed in him, and he believed in the coach, and he picked it. So at the end of the day, we got to support him as a family.
You know this game real well. What's one strength and one weakness?
His strength is the ability to, you know, think the game, play the game the right way. His weakness is, you know, he just got to keep getting better, you know, defensively as far as team defense. That'll come as Jay Wright teaches him.
Got any good stories about Jalen and Jay with the Bulls?
Yeah. I was the best player on that Bulls team in practice.
hey, tell Rick Brunson I need my Corvette back. He bought my Corvette for about 3.5 months.
That's what you do to a rook.
I know. You guys did a lot more than that.
always love checking in with Rick Brunson. Had a 9-year NBA career, played for John Chaney at Temple before that, and had time overseas, and he's taught his son very, very well. Hey, we saw Jalen Brunson last year, 54 points for Stevenson High School against Jahlil Okafor and Whitney Young in the state championship, state tournament. No surprise, we got another good Chicago player playing here. Okafor, Alexander, Tyler Ulis, Jabari Parker, Anthony Davis, Wayne Blackshear, D. Rose, Iman Shumpert. These are all guys from here playing on this stage that are going to make an impact in college. Nice floating shot by the future Memphis Tiger, Dedrick Lawson.
Yes, it was.
For Brunson now, Villanova, they lose Darren Hilliard, they lose Javon Pinkson, but they do return Dylan Ennis, Josh Hart comes back, Ryan Archidiakono, Daniel Oshefu, who really is game blossom this year, yep. Most definitely offensively and defensively. So, you know, I think he's going to come in right away. The ball is going to be in his hands with Ryan Archidiakono, and that's what Jay Wright loves to do. They play small ball. They get after you defensively. It really is applicable to the mindset that Jalen Brunson brings to the floor.
This kid Diallo is a GPS. Oof. The basketball just finds his hands. Good finish off the offensive rebound down low.
He's got 6 in the second half, 14 points for the game, and 8 rebounds as well for Sheck Diallo. Undeclared, number 11 player in the country, top 4 power forward. Brunson to Bragg, an open 3 for the lead. Slap back out towards the top. Loose to Brunson. Trier, a 3 for the lead, and he got it down. West on top. 13 points for the future Arizona Wildcat.
I appreciate the unselfishness. A lot of times, playing against the top players around the country, tough to get familiar with where they like the basketball, their strengths and weaknesses. I appreciate the fact that each of these guys are looking to make the guy around them better.
Hey, Diallo is on the ball once again. Here's Brunson. Trier wanted it up top.
Brunson, the Superman, the two-hand stuff.
Well, you know Jaden trusts him because he let him jump over the top of him, so it's only right.
That's right, the selfie dunk you saw at halftime. Dwayne Bacon, the future Knoll, puts down 2. There's a timeout called for the East by Bruce Kelly of the Bullish School out of Potomac, Maryland. Bruce Kelly is the coach for the East today, along with Bob Brown and Marcus Townsend, and then Robert Smith is the head coach for the West out of Simeon High School.
You see a little pass by Brunson right here behind the back to Steven Zimmerman. Zimmerman is the most skilled big man in this class. I mean, he can play both in the low post and in the high post. He can knock down a 3-point jumper. He's a great runner, he can run the floor. You can see why his list is likes of KU, Kentucky, UCLA, Arizona, or UNLV. Now,
talk about UNLV here.
His mother, Lori Zimmerman, actually was the same classmate of the head coach of UNLV and Dave Rice. They graduated in 1991 together. And him being in there, being from that area, a lot of people are thinking that Zimmerman is going to go to UNLV, but he's made it a very adamant statement that he is, as you see,
the selfie dunk,
that, you know, all these other schools are still on his list, and he has not made a decision yet.
Steven Zimmerman, when he was a freshman, I remember you and I were sitting at Hoop Hall in Massachusetts watching him play with Shabazz Muhammad, who ended up being an MVP of this game.
I'm glad Shabazz got those birth certificate issues.
Oh, Lord.
Cold-blooded. There's Swanigan at the top.
Changing the subject.
Let's segue this so naturally. Rab throwing it down. Beautiful feed by PJ Tosher. I got paid to sit next to these two guys. This is how awesome my night is, man. This is awesome. Great game, too. 64-61. West on top. A half dozen dunks apiece. 5 minutes into the second half in what's been a competitive game. Antonio Blakeney off target, future LSU Tiger. And a shot.
I like that.
Simmons right there.
And that's the kind of mentality you should have right there. Ben Simmons is a top player in this class, but Ivan Rabb has something to say about that.
No question. You guys get tangled up, you turn around, and you look at that license plate number.
Some of the intensity we're seeing on the floor. Some of the smiles, too, here in Chicago. This game has taken him from Seattle to Dallas to OKC to Tulsa, and now the Finley Prep star, Alonzo Trier, is having a great game on his way to play for the Arizona Wildcats. Big night tonight for Alonzo Trier. He's put together 13 points, 4 rebounds as well in this game. And Alonzo is with Quinn Kesnick right now.
Alonzo, you said it all started with you and your mom, Marcy, and some of those practice sessions. Describe them.
Definitely, man. It started when I was a young kid. My mother used to take time out of her day to, you know, to rebound for me every day. I would make 500 shots every day.
What's it going to take for Arizona to get over the top? What's your role?
My role would be come in, you know, to compete right away, come in and try to be effective on the offensive end and lock in on defense.
You've been focused all week and working hard. What is the biggest lesson that you've learned this week?
I've just learned about, you know, coming in and giving back, affecting lives, not just on the basketball court, but with us as human beings and players.
Where's that winning attitude come from?
It just comes from my competitiveness from starting when I was a little kid, and my motivation is from my mother and God.
Thank you, Alonzo. Adam?
Really classy kid to talk to. Alonzo's been great this week with us. 64-63. Blakeney for the East puts him back on top with 4 consecutive points.
I can't stress enough how don't just look at the work ethic and the skill and attribute that to why these young men are being successful. I really appreciate how their faith, their philanthropic endeavor, how genuine they are about being good people. And just so happened that they're really talented basketball players.
You really have to appreciate it. And we're lucky because we spend 3-4 days with these kids. And we get to hang around them. We get to talk to them. We get to interview them. It may not always translate, or you may not always get the sense for these kids sitting at home just watching 20 minutes and 20 minutes of basketball. We get that sense. And it's really great, especially like you've talked about the social media age, how classy and humble and grounded a lot of these kids are.
These kids are byproducts of their backgrounds, and it came a long way. And, you know, I got some beef, Adam. I got some beef.
So, hit me with it, man.
At JM Howe 12, at JM Howe 12, tweeted me and said, college athletes should not be paid. A free education is paying them enough. So Jay Billis did an article with the Wall Street Journal. And just to give you some facts, you see Jaylen Brown fly here. All right, last year's games averaged 10.5 million viewers, with more than 21.2 million viewers, fans tuning into the NCAA championship between University of Kentucky and Connecticut last year, okay? The National College Athletic Association, the NCAA,
nonprofit,
will rake in $800 million from the broadcasting rights to this year's tournament.
That's up from
a more than 500% increase from 2 decades ago. Yet this represents a mere sliver of the nearly $12 billion in revenues that flow annually through college athletic programs.
That's directly from the Wall Street Journal.
Quote from the Wall Street Journal. Are you kidding me that these players are being exploited? Like, now, granted, it could be capitalism, tell me whatever you want to call it, but maybe we should structure something where we should incentivize education. Maybe we should say, whatever program, whatever revenue that program generates, let's put that revenue aside. Let's put an escrow. Let's give a small percentage to the player and incentivize the player by saying, okay, if you graduate with this GPA, you are incentivized to this small percentage that's been left in escrow for these 4 years and incentivize education, actually. But you can't sit here and say anymore that a free education is enough. It's not. Not when these coaches are signing $6, $7 million deals and have shoe contracts that are out of control. It's not.
Apparel deals. Jaylen, on the Grant Lab basketball hour, I remember you telling the guys something. How many revenue streams do coaches have?
You get paid from the school. You pay from the shoe company. You have a television deal, a radio deal, your own likeness. You have the opportunity to do endorsements and appearances.
Your own fantasy camp.
I remember you distinctly saying this, and that stuck out to me the revenue streams for these coaches. Newman gets fouled by Simmons. Still enjoying Ben Simmons, number one player in the country, doing it at both ends of the floor. We call him a positionless player because he can play any position. He's done a lot of good things tonight. The block here at one end.
I appreciate the players diving on the floor multiple times to come up with loose balls. See, scrappy for the loose ball. Drops a dime for the easy dunk.
To his future teammate, Antonio Blakeney at LSU, part of the number six recruiting class in the country. I think it's an important discussion. We just scratched the surface of it. There's a lot more detail that I'm sure is involved and will be delved into over the course of the next several years of this argument. So, you know, don't crush the three of us for trying to solve the world's problems in just one night. But,
no, but things have changed.
I think it's an important conversation. You guys articulated it well.
It will happen. There was a time in collegiate basketball where players did get meal money or a stipend.
Simmons, the floater, giant killer from 15.
That had icicles.
That's part of his versatility. And you don't see a lot of guys at 6'9", 6'10", that have floaters in their game. Not only his vision, but his ability to finish around the rim and make players around him better shows you why Ben Simmons is such a special player. He's running the point right now. You have Antonio Blakeney running the two.
Again, this guy's 6'9". He's the best passer in the class, according to Paul Biancardi. Jaylen Brown, number two player in the nation. How about that? You get the top two players in the country playing together. That's still pretty cool. Trying to back down Blakeney. Nice move and runs into Swanigan, who gets called for the foul. We'll get to know Ben Simmons a little bit. Originally from Australia, moved to Florida at Montford Academy in January of 2013. Paul Biancardi says he's a legit number one. The NBA loves his size, his versatility. He's listed as a power forward, but he can play any position. Son of Dave and Julie, one of six kids. He'll talk with us when you come back to Chicago. The LSU Tigers, Johnny Jones, head coach. Two of the best prospects in the country are on their way to Baton Rouge. The number one player in the country is Ben Simmons. Antonio Blakeney is the number 14 player, number two shooting guard in the nation. And those two guys have done some nice things so far. There's Blakeney, and now Quinn Kesnick is with the number one player, Ben Simmons.
That was what we thought your best run of the evening. How were you able to turn it up a notch?
Just sharing the ball. I'm trying to play as a team player. That's how I play. So it's a bit different playing with guys who are, you know, just trying to score and not pass the ball. But at the same time, we're good at trying to win. So
what do you think it's going to be like going to LSU, where you will be the face of the program?
For me, I think it'll be good as a freshman, but I'm just trying to be elated going in. I know it's hard being one of the youngest guys, but me and Antonio going in, we're going to try and, you know, lead the team.
Yeah, I was going to ask you about Antonio next. Is that comforting?
Definitely. You know, he's a scorer, so I like to pass the ball. He can shoot the outside shot, so it's good. We work well together.
Growing up in Australia, did you even know about the McDonald's All-American game?
I've heard of a few games, but I didn't know it was this big.
Different time change. You'd probably have to wake up pretty early to watch it, Adam.
Definitely.
No doubt about it. Former rugby player, former Australian rules football player. His dad, Dave, was a player as well. Played internationally. This is what the LSU class is sitting at. Number six in the country, Simmons and Blakeney, Jarrell Martin, Jordan Mickey, both declaring for the NBA draft. It'll be a little bit more guard heavy, perhaps, with Tim Quarterman and Keith Hornsby still there. We'll see what LSU has in store for the rest of an improving SEC. Seven teams in the top 25 in the recruiting rankings. Dwayne Bacon is able to put it in. He's talking about undeclared guys. Jaylen Brown, the number two player in the nation, still undeclared. He's with Jay Williams.
Here with Jaylen Brown. Jaylen, obviously you're undecided. What's going into your decision? Why are you waiting?
I'm just taking my time with the process. You know, it's a lot of the things that go into your decision. I'm just trying to have fun with it and just try to make the best decision possible.
What's your experience been like this week? And have you been trying to make a statement, proving everybody that you are the top player in the class?
Yeah, man, I've been having a good time. You're not going to see another event with all these players on the floor like this. So I'm just trying to have fun with it. Hopefully, he can pull out a win.
Last question, who are you rooting for in the Final Four?
This is great, because I got Isaiah Briscoe to my right. I got Luke Kennard to my left. Luke Kennard's going to Duke. Isaiah Briscoe is going to Kentucky. So I'm trying to know, who's your favorite team? Who are you picking to win it?
I'm going with Kentucky.
All right, there you go, Adam. I don't know if that's a precursor. I don't know.
He said Kentucky is the best program in the country. He's got to find out if it's the best program for him, which I thought was a pretty mature way to approach that subject.
At this point of his life, where he chooses to go to school, that's the biggest decision. So take your time.
Here is Lawson for three. soft Chicago rims. Just couldn't get the final bounce in a region foul against Sheck Diallo.
That's because he had a nice follow through. You get the ball when you have a nice follow through. Always follow through, especially when you're in the front of the basket.
Talk to me, Jay Rose, if you're a fan of the West and how it's going to be won. OKC, Memphis, Portland, LA, part of NBA Friday presented by State Farm.
What a good thing is three of those teams have all-stars pitchers. One of those teams have Jeremy Lin pitching.
I'm sorry, man. I love Jeremy Lin, too, but that was cold-blooded. That's coming your way Friday. Dwayne Bacon coming to the rim. Diallo could not clean it up. Bacon tipped it back up and in for Florida State.
I like Jeremy Lin as well.
Yes, yes.
But that's the difference between analyzing high school players, collegiate players, and professional players.
Yes.
When your team is going to the lottery, it's not for a national basketball analyst to act like he's on the team staff. They have a terrific team. They won 16 championships. I hate to see Kobe Bryant injured. We know the Lakers are going to be back. Hated to see Julius Randle get injured.
Right.
But this year, we got him ping pong ball.
Should Kobe lay it down, man?
Never.
Never?
Mm-mm.
Are you just saying that because you did an interview with Mark Brandon?
No, I'm saying that because he was averaging 25 this year.
I love Kobe. When do you call it quits?
He getting $25 million to play basketball.
I'm just asking. I'm trying to stir the pot, just asking.
Thomas Bryant, undeclared, at the line. Could make a decision by the end of the week, he said. Indiana is recruiting him the hardest. Missouri is recruiting him. Syracuse and Kentucky haven't really made a ton of contact with him as of late. He's talked with Yogi Ferrell. He talked with James Blackman, Robert Johnson, Troy Williams. Says he's happy Tom Crean is getting the vote of confidence from Indiana. So, Thomas Bryant, could we see him with the Hoosiers? And maybe how does it impact it? Impact Indiana?
I think so. And obviously, you know, you think about the Hoosiers and that guard play that they have.
Bacon to Diallo. Smooth. Keep going.
But I think that Indiana made the right decision in keeping Tom Crean.
Yep.
Obviously, this year was a little bit of a struggle, but he's done nothing but win there at that university. And I get that all these universities want to win, but there's also a rebuilding process that each school has to go through, and he's able to do that.
I appreciate what Bryant learned from his high school coach. Why be average? It's as close to the bottom as it is to the top.
Yeah. Bacon to Diallo. It's been fun to watch these guys go to work. Diallo's got 16 points and 10 rebounds in this game. He's been one of the stars so far. 83-72, the score right now.
You know what would be awesome right now? A large order of hot McDonald's fries with extra salt. That's a request for next year.
Big shout out to Worldwide West. Worldwide West in the building here behind us. The most interesting man on the planet.
You want to know where that name came from?
Where?
I was sitting on the airplane, and we were waiting for a passenger. And the plane was being held. Wes comes walking on the plane. It was him. And right then, I came with the term, Worldwide West.
Nice.
That's so you're the one that came up with
you
it?
You coined it.
100%.
All you right. coined it. And Jay-Z uses it in songs, and now everybody knows who Worldwide West is. That's power. Jalen Rose has some
Everybody
power.
Knows who Worldwide West is, but nobody knows who Worldwide West is. It's amazing. Man.
That was the most philosophical thing Jay Williams has said all night long tonight.
There's a
that
lot
was pretty
more where
impressive.
That came from.
Can't wait. Can't wait for the next 9 minutes of Zen mastering from Jay Williams. It's going to be great. Here is Diallo right off the inbounds taking a jumper. Bacon tried to grab it, and here comes Malachi Richardson, the only Syracuse commit, blocked by Lawson. Brunson to the inside, flipping it. Can't get it to fall. And here comes numbers for the East. Diallo with Bryant. Diallo spinning. Left-hand laid it in.
I'm a huge fan of Diallo. I talked about it earlier in the game. A will player because he's going to continue to compete, take charges, block shots, rebound the basketball. But he also shows the skill. Here he is in transition.
East ball.
18 points for Sheck Diallo.
Making the play. Jalen Brunson goes for the steal. Gets put in the spin cycle. Finishes with the left.
B button right there. 85-72. East on top with the ball. Evans trying to drive, and Juwan Evans out of Dallas nearly put one home, headed to Oklahoma State. One more look, man.
Initially, I thought he was going to drop it off for the dunk. He said, nah, this McDonald's All-American. I'm taking this easy deuce.
The most most recent commit of the 24 guys in this game is going to Maryland. That's Diamond Stone. He's with Jay Williams.
Diamond, why Maryland?
No, I just feel like it was the right place for me. You know, I like Coach Hurst as a coach. You know, I like, you know, Romello Trim was a great point guard. You know, I feel like he'll give me the ball.
Now, you gave the ref out there a black eye. He's hurt, and he said you elbowed him. Literally, the ref has a black eye. How'd that happen?
Man, I don't know, to be honest with you. You know, I just looked over, and he was just gushing. It was just black. You know, I was just looking, I didn't know what to do. So, you know, he told me, you know, I gave him a black eye, and I was just like, point out my muscles.
No flex zone. Always. All right. There you go, Diamond Stone.
I guess Steve Hanacki should have known better in the no flex zone. Look at the left eye shiner right there for Steve, man.
And in the Big Ten, he's going to tighten and tone up, yep, work on his body, get in shape, and be a force.
That's something he said he needed to work on, has to get his body fat percentage down to about 10. It's at about 13, 14 right now. And he's going to be part of a very good front court. Robert Carter's the transfer from Georgia Tech coming in. You hope Devontae Dodd can put on some weight. They'll still have Lehman and Nickens on the perimeter, along with Melo Trimble, who's coming back.
Look, Diallo showing on the pick and roll, rotating back to the paint.
Woof, Trier.
That's exactly what you do to a shot blocker.
15 points for the future Wildcat. Bacon was looking for Diallo, maybe not clean on that. And Alonzo Trier with the right hand is followed up by P.J. Dozier.
Yeah, Evans was a little shaken up on the previous play.
Yep. 7:25 to play, officials timeout, Juwan Evans.
Timeout on the floor.
Took a shot to the face. Hopefully he's all right. He can commiserate with Steve Hanacki, the referee who's got that black eye, as well from Diamond Stone. It's been a fun night in Chicago. 7:25 left, 87-76, the East on top.
The 2015 McDonald's All-American Game is brought to you by Powerade. We're all just a kid from somewhere. Powerade, power through.
Since its inception in 1961, I'm reading this straight off the card, training at Hamburger University has emphasized consistent restaurant operations, procedures, service, quality, and cleanliness. It celebrates the history, as you see, of the McDonald's High School All-American Games. And maybe the best part of the week for a lot of these kids, the most important high fives they'll get all week long. They come on Sunday. The boys get to visit the Ronald McDonald House here in Chicago, sign autographs, they decorate cookies, they spend time with families who use the house as a home away from home as they fight their child's illness. Forget about basketball, is what one player said. This is the most important day of the week. More than $10 million raised for Ronald McDonald House charities since their inception. Great stuff. 87-76, the East has a lead on the West with 7:25 to play. More high school basketball coming your way starting Thursday, and more college basketball coming your way as well. It's going to be a great week even before the Final Four starts. On the college level, we've got the College Slam Dunk and Three-Point Championship.
I'll be a judge.
You'll be a judge for that, 7 Eastern. And then it leads you to Madison Square Garden. Stanford survived against Old Dominion despite an early lead. Miami survived. Pretty bad shooting night for them and for the Temple Owls. That's the championship game. Johnny Dawkins, Jim Larrinaga, great coaching matchup at 9 Eastern from the Garden.
If you have a Ronald McDonald House in an area around you, I encourage you to go and support. Oh, if you can make a donation, very much do so. But if you can go spend some time with some of these kids and see their faces, it puts life in perspective.
And also it plants the seeds for athletes to give back to their communities. So many athletes, while they do a good job of giving back to their community and they deserve to be commended, there are so many more that forget where they come from. And I think that's really selfish. So to see these young men learn how, yes, I'm a terrific basketball player, but it's not just about me. That's a trait that takes you a long way, a character.
But you know, to a point though, Jalen, I think our society is a little bit messed up. All we do is report negativity. And we report all the things that these athletes do wrong. And a lot of these athletes do take the time to give back to charities and do things not for the headlines, but because it's the right thing to do.
I had a great time talking with a lot of these very humble young men. One of them is Ivan Rabb. He's with Quint Kesnick. A couple schools still on his list.
Oakland, California led your team to a state championship. You said it's down to two, Arizona and Cal. What's the biggest difference?
The biggest difference between the two programs is Arizona's already established. I mean, they get deep in the tournament every year. And Cal, I mean, they have a new coaching staff, and they're very hungry. And they're looking for somebody like myself to come into the program, try to turn things around. And if I was to go there, I'd possibly be able to get people to come with me.
So do you want to be the face of a program, or do you want to be a good player for a top program?
That's the issue. I'm trying to figure out what I want to do, what legacy I want to leave.
Is it a decision you're going to make, or is it a decision your family makes?
It's a decision that I'm going to make, because I'm the one that's going to have to live with it and play there and be there for as long as I have to be. So that's my choice.
What's the pull in Oakland, Cal being right down the road?
Of course, everybody wants me to stay home. So, I mean, I know if I stay there, I mean, I'll have great energy, great fan support, and I know I'll be able to help the program in a big way.
Watching your defense tonight, it kind of stands out. How do you best describe what you're able to do on the defensive end?
On the defensive end, I think I'm very I do a lot of different things on the court. I mean, like tonight I'm guarding Ben on the wing, and that's something I've been working on. I'm 6'11", but I try to move my feet with the best of them.
Zimmerman misses the dunk. It's kind of the story on Monday night in our dunk contest, Adam.
Thanks very much, Quinn. Cal needs him the most by far. Quanzo Martin going into his second year. Tyrone Wallace, Jabari Bird, Jordan Matthews, but they're thin up front. They got good guards, but they need some help up front. And Ivan Rabb would be a huge addition for the Bears.
Ivan Rabb, very, very skilled, can do a lot of things, play inside and out. But one of the best things I saw from him in this game, but as we saw before we went to break, him and Ben Simmons were in the mix for a loose ball. And I think it's little things like that that can tell you a lot about a player.
Little stare down afterwards.
And it's the fact that Ivan Rabb has a chip on his shoulder. Now, I'm not saying that Ben Simmons doesn't, but usually in that situation, you can tell which player just decides to give up on the ball. And Ivan Rabb snatched the ball away from Ben Simmons, pretty much saying, no, this is mine. And I think it says a lot about a player's mentality.
Ownership.
Exactly.
Briscoe with a smooth-looking long two. He's got 11, a 10-point lead for the East. West on offense. Here's Trier. Future Arizona Wildcat could not connect. Zimmerman fighting with it against Brown. Here comes Jaylen Brown to Isaiah Briscoe. Stone is there to follow it up. He's got a dozen tonight.
The difference in this game really is plays like that, just capitalizing on runouts, long rebounds, turning them into three-on-two, two-on-one situations, and or uncontested layups or dunks.
Simmons against Zimmerman, and he draws the foul, and the number one player in the land is going to the foul line. Diamond Stone has really showed up big tonight. It's been fun to watch.
Diamond Stone and Robert Carter will form one of the top backcourts next year in college basketball. Maryland is a real player, a team that can win the national title next year with a guy like Diamond Stone.
Found an interesting note today, and I just thought of it because you mentioned Maryland. Since 1998, only two teams have won a national title on the men's side without a McDonald's All-American. The 02 Maryland Terrapins, who I know you know very well, Jay, and
Steve
then
Blake, very well.
The 2014 UConn Huskies. Those are the only two teams that did it without a McDonald's All-American. That's where it's gone to in terms of recruiting. And you see the possible starting lineup. Are you kidding me for the Maryland Terrapins next year, potentially?
Demonte Dodd can come off the bench. You have Diamond Stone and Robert Carter as starters, along with Jake Lehman. He can play that three positions, stretch it out. Jared Nickens comes back, and obviously Melo Trimble made the right decision to come back to school. I think he could have been a top 25 pick, maybe a first rounder, but I think his stock will go nothing but up and up as he will be the feature player next year once again for the Terps.
And while it's virtually impossible who's going to have success on the collegiate and or pro level, that's what makes this game so unique and so special, and why it's had the staying power, the statistic you mentioned.
Briscoe to Brown for two, a 14-point lead for the East inside of four.
That's also, and a lot of people talk about, you know, oh, this guy should go, he needs to come back for another year. A lot depends on what you're coming back to.
Sure.
You know, so
Melo Trimble's coming back. That's a guy you want to play with.
Yeah, but he's coming back to a loaded team that's only going to make him look better instead of him coming back to a team that's decimated. And now his numbers have to be inflated so we don't break him down more.
3:41 to play in Chicago. It's been a great night for the All-American game. We'll close it out when you come back to the show. Fun stuff tonight. 98-84, the East on top. 3:41 to play, and let's make some people angry on Twitter right now.
Oh, you know we love to stir the pot.
Jay's
here, Adam.
NBA ready. Your top five out of this game that could be NBA ready, and you're saying right now in their current state.
In no particular order, Jaylen Brown, Malik Newman, I think he's on that list. Ivan Rabb, Caleb Swanigan, Wayne Bacon, and Ben Simmons is on that list, too. I had top six. Ben Simmons should have been at the top of the list. I need to talk to the font team. They set me up.
Yeah, sure. Good carpenter doesn't blame his tools, Chip.
Ben Simmons is on that list as well.
But you know what? I wanted to ask you guys about this, because and we referenced it earlier. The reason we talk about the NBA with some of these guys is because, you know what? There's NBA scouts here. They're looking at these guys now. They're going to be looking at these guys for the next 12 to 13 months in case they do decide to go one and done from where they're at. The deadline for underclassmen to declare right now is April the 26th. That's a very difficult time. Let's say you're Willie Cauley-Stein. Probably going to go to the NBA.
You have 2 weeks to make that decision.
You play in the Final Four. You got 2.5 weeks to try to figure it all out. There are some changes that you're hoping will be made and will be made, as a matter of fact, over the course of the next couple of years.
Well, the NBA, the NCAA, and the NABC have joined forces to offer a proposed solution. And here are the bullet points for the plan, pretty much. It will move the date college players can withdraw from NBA draft back about 5 weeks from late April to late May, which gives players enough time to evaluate. Underclassmen will participate in an invitation-only combine in mid-May that would allow NBA teams to evaluate or offer feedback on their NBA draft prospects. Now, I think that does wonders for a lot of these kids, right? Because now, if the combine is invitational only, this is for seniors, underclassmen, and overseas players, now it gives you a better sense of, if you don't get an invitation, the chances of you being drafted aren't likely. So don't come out early. Stay in school. It's that kind of feedback. I think kids need more time to really come to a conclusion on whether they want to leave school or not.
The NBA is a blood sport, and I mean that literally. The lifespan is 3 or 4 years. You want to make an informed decision. It's one thing to accomplish your dream and make it to the league, but staying power is always key.
Now, this would be very beneficial for this class, because in 2016, that's when they proposed that this agreement will come into effect.
Right.
But it's absolutely ludicrous that a kid, you know, if you put in the paperwork to apply for the draft, you forfeit your college eligibility.
Automatically. Brunson, pull up, pop, 4-3. Kennard is there for the rebound for the East, who lead it by 14 points, 2:20 to play. Here is Dwayne Bacon. Got it lodged, but a foul was called. And a reminder that the Women's Final Four begins on ESPN on Sunday night. Dawn Staley was there as a player in the early 90s. Now she takes the Gamecocks into Tampa to take on Notre Dame and then Maryland and UConn. Brenda Freese's team has its toughest task of the season going up against the dynamic Huskies as Gino Auriemma tries to continue the push for history for the UConn Huskies. Starts on Sunday from Tampa on ESPN. Malachi Richardson just checked into the game. There is Carlton Bragg, who's on his way to Kansas. I want to talk about Malachi Richardson. The Syracuse situation is an interesting one. They do get to go to the postseason next year, and they're going to get Richardson as part of their recruiting class.
Well, they have the top four recruiting class, and I think Richardson's going to fit in perfectly with that team. And, you know, obviously NCAA has named the sanctions, and some of the wins, I think they're going to be appealed. Some of the wins for Jim Boeheim will be vacated as of right now, but it does not affect the recruiting class and them playing next year.
Juwan Evans, future Oklahoma State Cowboy, on a deep two. And the East leads at 105-88, 150 to play. Sheck Diallo had 18 points and 10 rebounds. Ben Simmons, 7 points, 10 rebounds, 3 assists. Blakeney had 14. Ingram had 15. Trier with 17. Dozier with 14. Rabb with 10. Added 6 rebounds as well. Deonta Davis had 6 points and 9 boards. This was a nice variety of guys we got to see. It wasn't just one guy, and certainly some stick out. But amongst 24 players, 23 who played, again, Henry Ellenson, who's part of Marquette's recruiting class, was hurt with a hand injury, so he couldn't play. But most of the guys, 23 guys we saw, they made some kind of impact positively.
And a couple of guys that made an impact on me today after seeing them a little bit closer, Rabb, Briscoe, and Diallo. I know I talked about them ad nauseum, but his motor is terrific. He has a double-double in this game. He deserves to be MVP.
I would agree with you on Sheck Diallo. I think the kid's so talented. He does so many things. Now, he only has one block, but he's altered so many shots around the rim. And that's a stat that you can't actually, you know, look at. But I mean, his defensive ability, and you know, he reminds me a little bit of Willie Cauley-Stein, maybe not the same size and height, but his ability to in ball screen switch.
He can defend one through four at the very least.
That goes a long way when you can switch in a ball screen and still have the height and size to block shots or deter shots.
This is why Willie Cauley-Stein is considered one of the best defenders in America, because it's 7 feet tall. He can guard.
He might be the gem. He might be the gem from that team. Him and Devin Booker might be the gem of that team. Everybody's big on Karl-Anthony Towns, and as well, he could be the top pick taken in the draft. As you see Luke Kennard, a Duke recruit right there, along with Chase Jeter going to Duke. But, I mean, Willie Cauley-Stein, his ability to switch, he guards point guards. You don't find a lot of big men that can do that. He has the footwork to do so.
And also, when you have a junior that's as productive as he is, they set the tone before you get to the game, making sure players are going to class, working hard in practice, being willing to sacrifice for the greater good of the basketball team. The game becomes fun.
Wait, did you just say there's a junior associated with Kentucky basketball? That's an anomaly.
SportsCenter's coming up next. I know Jalen's going to have some opinions on this, too. I'm sure we'll talk about it tonight. 51 points for
against
James
who,
Harden against the Sacramento Kings. Sid the Kid with his 300th. Talk about Sidney Crosby. Bucci Man, Steve Levy. John Butchergrass, Steve Levy have SportsCenter coming up next in 63 seconds of game time.
Jay Rose, MVP. Do you go with James Harden? Do you go with Steph Curry with that shot boy? Or do you go to OKC?
You got to remember the media votes. So they get caught up in the hype. And what has happened to that award is it's either become two things, Jay. Either the best player on the best team or the best player that's perceived to do the most with the least. And in this case, that's going to be James Harden, in my opinion, because Dwight Howard has missed so much basketball. But Steph Curry has the ultimate award. He plays on the best team.
That's right. We're talking about MVPs in the NBA. What about the MVP in this game? Let's go to Quinn Kesnick.
Tight squeeze here on the sideline. Our MVP tonight is going to be Shaq Diallo. First of all, congratulations. Shaq, what was the biggest challenge that you faced?
I mean, you know, I have a lot of things to do. I got a rebound and a fast break. I make a lot of points with my teammates. I always thank my teammates to give me a ball. I'm so happy to be here, too.
What do you think made the difference for you?
I mean, it's a lot of different because that's the kind of all-star game. It's not like a team game. You know, like everybody play your own thing.
Soft-spoken, but you spoke big on the court tonight. Congratulations, our MVP, Adam.
Great kid, Shaq Diallo. Double-double tonight, 18 points, 10 rebounds, 8 of 14 shooting. The highest motor of anybody in this game. That's what Paul Biancardi, our director of national recruiting, said. It's what Reggie Rankin, part of our great crew in RecruitingNation.com, talked about. That showed up in the 40 minutes on the floor tonight for Shaq Diallo. Shot clock is off. It'll be an East victory.
Toss it up.
Oh, Luke Kennard passing up on the three. He'll try to get the assist to a guy who'll face in the ACC next year in Dwayne Bacon, who's probably going to be a part of what I think should be a preseason top 25 team at FSU.
Florida State will come to play next year. You think about it, they get a couple of guys back. Monte Brandon comes back. Aaron Thomas, who was hurt for the year, he comes back along with Dwayne Bacon, big time.
Kennard throws it down. One 11-91, 6 seconds left. Bragg for three.
Kick it out. Kick it out. Exclamation point.
Won't get it down in time, but Bryant throws down a dunk just for a little bit of style to cap it off. 111-91. There's the MVP, Shaq Diallo, at 18 points and 10 rebounds. Great time here in Chicago. 111-91, the final. Final thoughts for you guys.
I just appreciate how these young men and women, the next 48, have handled themselves. A lot of requests, a lot of demands the last couple of days. They all handled themselves with class. We had two great games.
This is the first step in the process for all these guys to get to where they want to be eventually. And Ben Simmons is impressive. He's even more impressive in person.
Great stuff all week long from our fantastic crew here in Chicago. For Quint Kesnick, Jalen Rose, Jay Williams, Adam Amin saying so long from the United Center. The East wins it 111-91 over the West. Coming up next, SportsCenter, right now.
At Jalen Brown's list of schools, he has 10 of them.
You're not a fan of that, I know, Jalen. I can understand
why.
Well,
it's not a surprise for Jalen to be undecided. But 10 schools?
Hey, you know what I will say about it, though? I do like the fact you don't need to rush this decision.
Sure.
You could take your time.
It's an important decision.
You should fill out all your options. Yeah. You know, go on your recruiting trips. Get wine and dine. You know what I mean? Get told what you can do and find the right fit. I shouldn't say wine and dine.
that's the three of us after this game today. Well, if you're a fan of the triple-double, if you want to know how the West is going to be won, these are your games. Oklahoma City takes on Memphis. Portland will take on Los Angeles. It's NBA Friday presented by State Farm. Starts with Kia NBA Countdown. What do we expect, Jalen, with those two games, by the way? As Evans takes it in and misses.
Playoff positioning in the Western Conference. Teams jockeying. The West playoff race is going to be awesome. Don't miss it.
Zimmerman, one of the best undeclared bigs, misses. There is Davis, who had 199 shot blocks last year to set a new Michigan record. Maybe one of the biggest recruits out of that state, out of that area in Muskegon in a decade.
Nice fundamentals. Got the offensive rebound, kept the basketball high, soft touch, easy two.
Thomas Bryant throws it down.
Check the hour is so special,
yeah,
so talented. His versatility, once again, you know, you're seeing a lot of these players who are 6'8", 6'9", who possess the talent to handle the basketball and make plays in traffic. Not only can he finish and he's an intimidating shot blocker, but he has a vision to find people in traffic as well.
Alonzo Trier flipping it back up and in, the only Arizona Wildcat commit in this game, but Sean Miller has another great recruiting class coming in next year.
But that's the beauty of basketball, Jay. Every 6'11 power forward has once been a 6'1 point guard.
Yes.
Always work on your entire package.
But I do like the old-fashioned center, too, like Diamond Stone. He's a center, legit old-school center.
He's going to be a part of a very, very good Maryland team next year. A lot of these guys are going to be part of very good programs next season, including the number one player in the country, Ben Simmons. More from the Shy when you come back. Some of the great memories and some of the great players that have been through the McDonald's All-American game. This is pretty decent.
The big ticket. Three,
two, little four. Paul Pierce action.
Paul Pierce had a hot top curl.
Vince Carter, one of the nastiest dunkers ever, got his start.
Vincent Lamar hot top.
Great stuff, man. The most all-time in terms of McDonald's All-Americans, UNC, with 65 of them. Duke is right there with 60. There's Michael Jordan's jersey here in the rafters at the United Center. No surprise, those are the blue blood programs that we think of more often than not. Recruiting is the lifeblood. It's the foundation. It's the basis for what ends up happening for programs and teams as we work forward the next several years with these guys.
Embrace the past. Prepare for the future.
Here is Chase Jeter, future Duke Blue Devil. It's rebounded by Isaiah Briscoe. Good Simmons, pass. Beautiful pass to Stone. That's what we're talking about. The vision of Ben Simmons, the best passer in the class.
I saw the exact same trait in this game last year with D'Angelo Russell.
Yeah.
Passing players open, anticipating, giving the basketball up early, seeing a play ahead. That's an innate skill.
At 6'9", he's the best passer in this class. A positionless player, Ben Simmons. He can play any position. Chase Jeter tight to the rim. Rap, doing what he's been doing all first half, cleaning up the glass. Out of Oakland, CA.
Normally the bigs and the effort players are more efficient in games like this, getting those cleanups, getting those drop-off dunks, jump hooks, and post-ups.
And something we've seen, 8 of the top 10 players in the rankings are bigs, power forwards and centers, and they all have a variety of skill sets. That's where the game's kind of going. You said it.
Absolutely.
There is Brown flipping it in. His first two. Undeclared out of Alpharetta, Georgia.
Under control. Nice touch. Finish off the backboard.
It's a traveling violation against Malik Newman. Let's get to know a little bit about the number two player in the country. Kansas and Kentucky are at the top of the list. UCLA, North Carolina, Michigan. He's been on visits there. He'll slot into small forward maybe if he goes to Kansas or Kentucky. Obviously, we don't know exactly who's staying, who's going. But if he goes to one of those two schools, he's going to have a slot more than likely right off the top.
What can Brown do for you? He'll be a starter next year.
Yeah. Wherever he goes.
He reminds me very much of Stanley Johnson, who plays for Arizona right now. That same kind of build. I think offensively he might be a little bit more gifted.
Okay.
But there's no doubt about it. You can only imagine Jalen Brown on the next level. He's a prototypical two guard. He can lock down other two guards in the league at 6'7".
And he does something I still haven't figured out how to do. Play defense.
Yeah.
This guy was picking
this is
up.
True. Yeah, you this were is true. One of the first. I was a bad defender, but
this guy was picking up 94 feet in a scrimmage. Those be the type of players that you just hate to go against. Like, just get off me.
I think yesterday he was trying to make a statement. And we talk about that all the time. Some players look at it, we talking about practice. We're talking about practice. But Jaylen Brown didn't take on that mentality yesterday. He came in here along with Ben Simmons, and they showed everybody this is why they have us labeled number one and number two in the country.
Briscoe gets called for that foul. Thursday night, a lot of exciting college hoops action. We'll have the 2015 State Farm College Slam Dunk and three-point championships leading you in to Stanford and Miami for the NIT championship from Madison Square Garden on ESPN and Watch ESPN. Very exciting games last night in the semifinals as Temple gave Miami a run. Old Dominion came all the way back to make it a close game against Stanford.
And we're going to take one of these Twitter questions real quick. At 34 Rhodes, giving you a shout out. Hey, Real Jay Williams, do you think LSU will make a major impact next year? I think they will with Antonio Blakeney and Ben Simmons. There's no doubt about it. Now, their front line will be a little bit limited considering they lose Mickey and Martin. But when you got the number one player in the country coming to your school, and you have some good wing players, Keith Hornsby, Josh Gray, Tim Quarterman. They have guards. It's going to lack at the post position, but they can definitely be a top team in the SEC.
We'll talk with Antonio Blakeney on the other side of the break when we get to the media timeout, too. Briscoe stepped back smooth.
Isaiah Briscoe.
He ties it back up at 25. Yeah, LSU's got the number six recruiting class in the country. The SEC has a half dozen teams in the top 25 of the recruiting rankings right now, led by Kentucky at the top.
Isaiah Briscoe, just a big combo guard. Physically just gifted, overpowers people, coached by the New Jersey players. Good old Jimmy Salmons, the head coach.
Jaylen Brown puts it in. He'll go to the line. Look at the LSU commits. The highest ranked commits, three of them since 2007 have come in the last 2 years. Jarrell Martin, who declared for the NBA draft along with Jordan Mickey. And then you have both Blakeney and Simmons on that list. So Johnny Jones making his mark now on the recruiting trail.
Well, Ben Simmons' father played in Australia, played overseas basketball.
Dave.
One of his really good friends is now the assistant coach at LSU. So smart move by Johnny Jones. You got to do what you got to do in order to get top recruits into your school.
That's David Patrick. He's the godfather of Ben Simmons, who picks up the steal. Watch him in the open floor. Well, he got into traffic and still was able to keep it alive. He's so fast. I think that's what stuck out, even though the play kind of broke down. His quickness was insane. Blakeney misses. Simmons there with the tap. And then a foul is called with 8:12 to play. This is the key losses for LSU. There they are. Mickey and Martin going to the NBA. Ben Simmons, Antonio Blakeney could fit right in. It's going to be a little bit more guard heavy in terms of what LSU is going to have next year.
There's some interesting names that have been entering the draft. I mean, you have Michael Frazier entering the draft from Florida. I don't really know about that. I don't know his situation. I don't know any of these guys' situations.
Sure.
But, you know, you question some of these decisions about kids leaving early.
And the decision ends up being, do you want to get drafted or do you want to have a long career?
Sure.
We came along in the era where we worked out. These guys trained. And so college has become a really good incubator for NBA talent. If you don't feel like in any way, shape, or form that your draft position is something that you're proud of, it's okay to stay in school, get that seasoning, and become a better basketball player. Coach Cal, this is basically his invitational game. He even said his players aren't ready after 1 year.
Right.
And he has some of the top players in the league right now.
Kentucky's going to go up against some very good recruits next year in the SEC and LSU. Get to know Antonio Blakeney, the number 14 player in the country, out of Sarasota, Florida, the Mr. Basketball Award winner over his buddy Ben Simmons. We'll talk with him on the other side. Only Duke and LSU have multiple commits in this game. We'll talk with one of them next. Six players from the McDonald's All-American game are going to be on a plane tomorrow headed to New York because they're getting set for the Dix High School Nationals, including Ben Simmons and his Montverde Academy team trying to win the title. It'll be the Dix Sporting Goods High School Nationals tomorrow at noon, starting off on ESPNU with coverage all weekend long. Adam, Jay, Jaylen are here. Quint Kasnick is over there somewhere. Where are you at, Quint?
I'm on the bench with Antonio Blakeney, who's headed to LSU. First of all, you're from Florida. Ben Simmons is from Florida. How do you win Mr. Basketball in Florida over Ben?
I mean, I don't know. I mean, Ben obviously didn't play a lot of games in Florida, so that could have weighed into it. But, you know, I had a great season, and he had a great season, so it could have went either way.
The standard of excellence and expectations will rise at LSU with you and Ben. Why was that appealing?
It was very appealing because, you know, I'm different. I don't want to be a trendsetter. I don't want to do the same thing everybody else is doing. You know, I want to start a tradition.
So you had options to play at some big-time name programs, obviously, but you chose your own path.
Yes, yes, just like I said, I want to be able to start something on my own. You know, me and Ben can start something the next year. You know, other good players come in. But Coach Donnie Jones, the last 3 years that he's been there, he's had good players. So we're not the first one. We just keep adding on.
What's the dream?
What's my dream?
Yeah, what's the dream at LSU?
Oh, it's, of course, win the SEC championship and make a run in the tournament.
What do you have to do to get the team there?
I mean, I just have to work hard, you know, listen to my coaches and lead the team.
Thanks, Antonio. Adam?
Quinn, thanks very much.
I'm different. Yeah, I'm different. I like that.
He sounded a little bit like him, too.
I like that. You know, it
was smooth.
It does take a unique kid to blaze their own path at a school like LSU. And Ben Simmons and him had a chance to do that. But not too soon. Not too soon, because Kentucky still have a great class, and Texas A&M has a top five recruiting class as well.
They're number three, as a matter of fact. Believe it or not, Texas A&M is the number three recruiting class in the country. The SEC wasn't this strong when you were going into college. I know Arkansas was good. They were en route to a title, but the rest of the SEC wasn't up to par. They might be getting there now.
It starts with the hiring of Coach Cal. Everybody got to catch up. He set the bar a lot higher. And how did he do it? So there are other schools that recruit what we consider the quote-unquote one-and-done players. So why does Cal get the label? It's because he owned it from the beginning.
Yeah.
While teams were selling going for 4 years and graduating, he was selling, if you listen to what I say, you could be in the NBA draft, take care of your family, and make millions of dollars.
Yep.
I like the way that sounds.
Alonzo Trier at one end for the Arizona Wildcats. Look at this play. Very smooth handles against Luke Kennard. But
a big-time block.
Sheck Diallo did it at both ends. We talked about the motor. Jalen's already talked about the motor. Diallo, the block at one end, the finish at the other, leading to a timeout. And take a look at the SEC teams. Kentucky, A&M, LSU, Florida, and then two more teams, including Arkansas, in the top 25.
And give Marquette, give Seymour Dowski some credit after 1 year in the Big East. They have a top 10 recruiting class as well, obviously led by McDonald's All-American Henry Ellison here. But, you know, back to your original point about Cal, Jalen, you know, he has such a way about him. First off, he's a player's coach. And let me tell you how he does it, too. So Malik Newman goes for his unofficial visit, right? He's down there summertime hanging out, seeing Cal, seeing the team. By the way, Cal has a fantasy camp, all right, where he has about 15,000 to 20,000 people that come in to see a lot of his former players come back and play in a game, in an all-star game. All right, so Malik Newman's down there, and he gets a chance to meet Drake. He gets a chance to meet John Wall. He gets a chance to meet Derrick Rose. How can you sell your program better than seeing these all-stars right then and there?
John distinguished himself by basically showing that those other guys are dinosaurs. I know about social media. I know what it takes to get you to the next level. And he embraced it and he owned it.
I was appreciated Drake's basketball career, I think, more than most of. 13 to
Georgia
1
State,
run.
Baby. Georgia State.
That's right.
Ron Hunter. RJ Hunter committed for the draft, too.
That's right.
He's going to be a pro. I'll tell you. That kid's good.
Trier puts it in. He's got seven plus the foul. Remember Ron Hunter from my Valpo days. He was an IUPUI head coach. Always energetic there, too. Nice start to the game for Trier going to Arizona.
And Trier just strong, overpowering his opponents. And I love the fact he can put his head down and get anywhere he wants on the court. You know, I was doing some research because we got the Final Four coming up next week.
Yeah.
A total of 18 McDonald's All-Americans are participating in the Final Four. A combined 17 play for Duke and Kentucky. The only other McDonald's All-American not on Duke and Kentucky, Brendan Dawson from Michigan State. There's not one McDonald's All-American on Wisconsin's team.
You know, I love to hear college coaches complain about the rosters that they recruit.
Here's Trier dumping it off underneath for Bragg, who's the lone Kansas commit in this game. He'll go to the free throw line. And this is what Arizona's class looks like. Sean Miller doing another great job. And think about some of the size that they already have. Now you're going to get a little backcourt help when you need it the most.
Well, you know, you think you're going to lose Stanley Johnson. He's probably going to be a top 10 pick. Rondae Hollis-Jefferson declared.
Waiting in the midst during this skills clinic. course, one of the great events of the week is the Powerade Jam Fest. These are the top four dunks that people were voting on. Little Isaiah Briscoe to Dwayne Bacon with one hand. Dwayne Bacon, who won the contest, leaping over our man Jalen Rose. But the winner amongst the fans, the best dunk, belongs to Steven Zimmerman. He got a little bit of help from Jalen Brunson. The let me take a selfie dunk. Jalen was taking a Snapchat video of himself getting dunked on by Steven Zimmerman. Awesome, awesome stuff. We'll have highlights of the first half for the boys' game coming up after this. Back to the 2015 McDonald's All-American Game from Chicago, Illinois. Fifth straight year we're here. The game has been played every year since 78 when it was played in Philadelphia to start it off. Ben Simmons is the number one player in the country. He had 5 points and he had 7 rebounds in the first half. The East with a 3-point lead. Back courtside, Adam Amin, Jay Will, Jay Rose. Two of the three were McDonald's All-Americans. You get to guess who. Opening thoughts from the first 20 minutes, guys. Let's start with you, Jay.
I like it. It's a competitive game. Yeah. I mean, yesterday, I was a little bit disappointed when we walked away from the scrimmage because the West blew out the East by about 30 points.
That's unacceptable. I agree.
And I like the fact that these kids now are buckling down with the lights on.
I like what I've seen from Brandon Ingram in the first half. I know we're going to talk a lot about Jaylen Brown and a lot about Ben Simmons, but 13 points in 13 minutes. Being really aggressive.
This is what we're taking a look at, Brandon Ingram, Jalen.
And at 6'8", 190, I like the fact one of his hidden talents, skateboarding, which tells you that he's good with his feet and with his balance. As you see him act up down low with the offensive board, again using the left hand with the finish around the hoop.
And then Isaiah Briscoe, a physical combo guard, who really is built ahead of his peers maturity-wise physically. And when you have mentors in your life like Kyrie Irving from St. Patrick's, like Carmelo Anthony who plays for the Knicks, like J.R. Smith who now plays for Cleveland, you're probably on your way to doing some pretty good things in your life.
Briscoe and Ingram are highlighted. Diamond Stone just looking over at Jay Williams. I'm sure he's going to want to talk to you at some point, Jay. 8 points in the first half. I love Sheck Diallo's motor. 8.7 boards, couple blocks. Trier is going to Arizona. Ivan Rabb is undeclared. We mentioned Isaiah Briscoe. Let's send it over to Quint Kestnicki. With him right now.
Look at these stats. 9 points, 4 rebounds, 2 assists in only 11 minutes. What was the last time you played 11 minutes and a half?
I can't even remember, honestly. But you know what? I'm just so blessed for the opportunity. You know, I want to thank McDonald's and everybody for giving me this wonderful experience.
You do the math, you're going to have a heck of a game. What's the mindset?
To win first. You know, I might try to get a triple double.
I like your attitude, and I like the smile. You always play with that big smile?
Well, you know, playing basketball is something I love to do. I love to have fun. I love to compete. So, you know, I'm enjoying myself.
How'd you get to the line so well?
Oh, that's my bread and butter. That's my bread and butter. You know, that's where I got my points from.
Keep it rolling, Isaiah.
Appreciate it.
Adam.
Thanks very much. Isaiah Briscoe, 5 of 6 at the line with four rebounds and a couple of assists as well.
You know, last year he had a foot injury, so he wasn't able to play for a long stretch. And I still think the conditioning for Isaiah Briscoe is something that needs to get better. But when you look at him, he has all the physical tools to be a legitimate pro. I mean, at 6'4", 6'5", he's strong enough. He has the height. You can see over the top of the defense. And he can really score the basketball. And he's really good, Jalen. As we both know, in order to be successful in the NBA, you have to have a high basketball IQ and understand how to be involved in a pick and roll. And he can do that.
And a physical presence. You could tell he's skill-wise working on his game, but he's not missing any workouts in the weight room.
I got a question for you guys because you just brought it up, and I am curious about it. With guys that are... We're talking about the NBA. I'm sure a lot of people are going, these guys are 18. Why are we talking about that? They still have college to go. But there are guys that are playing in the league right now that were in this game 2 years ago. A lot of these guys have thoughts of going to the NBA. You see a lot of one-and-dones from this game, play the year in college, go to the NBA. We can talk about the structure later, but just in terms of talent, that's why we're talking about this. There's a reason why NBA scouts are here tonight watching 24 guys.
Absolutely, and some may deem it a blanket statement, but in 2013, of the 24 players, say only 5 are in the NBA right now. Wiggins, Jabari, Aaron Gordon, Vonleh, and Julius Randle. That's slim pickings.
You just saw John Paxson in that shot a moment ago as well. He's one of the GMs that's here today.
You know what I appreciate about Pax being a GM of the Bulls? He's done a really good job building that roster. Hopefully his team can get healthy and make a run in the Eastern Conference playoffs. was walking through the hallway and they have some pictures of some of the best Bulls players ever. And I counted, it was 10 of them up. He had his cell phone. I appreciated that.
Wouldn't you have your
Jerry would definitely put a picture of himself.
He might have the shrine.
That's why I paid attention to it.
I'm actually going to put one of these photos of Jalen Rose that I have and actually put it on the face of the Jordan statue when we get out of here.
You know, a lot of fans out there ask these questions. So how can these guys be considered, you know, top 10 NBA draft picks? Because GMs look at it from a potential perspective. Potential. You know, last year, one of the players we didn't talk about at this game as much because we focused on the likes of Jahlil Okafor and some other players. We didn't talk about Karl Anthony Towns a lot last year. We didn't talk about him at all, really. And he's a guy right now, you talk about potential, and he could be the first pick taken in the NBA draft.
We were talking about D'Angelo Russell. We didn't get talk a ton about it. I wasn't here, but I watched the game. You guys didn't necessarily talk a ton about Russell. He ended up being one of the best guards in the country.
That's the beauty of sports. And right now, there are at least 50 guys at home watching this game that feel like politics is the reason that they're not here. So just because you're not playing in this game, that doesn't obviously mean you don't have what it takes to be a productive player at the next level and even taking a step further to the NBA. So stay motivated if you're at home watching this game.
By the way, I mean, so that's exactly what you're talking about when you think about Frank Kaminsky or Sam Decker or Nigel Hayes.
Yep.
The entire front line for the team that's in the Final Four, and none of those guys were McDonald's All-American.
Paul Biancardi made a great point to me when we were talking with him early in the week. Said, hey, some three-star guys turn into five-star college players. Some five-star college players play like three-star college players. You're hoping that Carlton Bragg's got something to do with it at Kansas.
But it starts by taking it personal. Right now, you should be watching this game fuming.
Yeah.
Smoke coming out of your ears.
Yeah.
Doing push-ups between the commercial breaks. Understanding you're going to get your chance to compete against these players.
That's what I was doing, actually, during the commercial break. Brunson on the push. He's a pure point guard.
You need to do a lot more.
I'm trying to get to Eddie George level. 3% body fat. Jay Williams claimed on air yesterday that he had 3%.
I didn't claim that. The player claimed it for me.
You didn't deny it, my man.
Of course I didn't deny it.
Trier gets fouled by Sheck Diallo. He'll go to the free throw line. Still love the motor for the center each New York native, Sheck Diallo, the native of Mali. Trier going hard to the rack. You got to appreciate that aggressiveness for the future Arizona Wildcat.
One of the things that all these young players are going to learn, especially when they get to the collegiate level, but even more so in the NBA level, a lot of players love to go to the basket and try to finish over bigs. You start going up in levels, you better start to develop. All those young players at home right now, develop a floater in your repertoire because you're going to need that offensively. You're not going to be able to overpower some of the bigs that are going to be on the next level.
Absolutely. That giant killer off 2 feet, yep. That floater or that runner off 1 foot all day. I remember in the 90s, that was considered a bad shot.
Kim English kind of got it going. Derrick Rose does it a lot here in Chicago, especially with the lack of explosiveness we've seen the last few years. Hey, we were talking about Jalen Brunson, great pure point guard. His dad played with you guys. He was an MVP of this game. He's here. He's with Quinn Kesnick, as a matter of fact.
Yeah, played in this game back in 1991. What is more anxious, playing in this game or watching Jalen play?
Playing is easy because, you know, you can control it. Right now, I'm just a dad having fun, but I get nervous watching my son play.
Monday night at Jam Fest, you could sense your son's toughness and focus, and he said a lot of that comes from you.
Nah, that comes from his mother. He gave me too much credit. He does a great job. You know, he's a great individual. He works hard, and we're just proud of him.
He had a lot of options. Why Villanova?
You know, it was my son's decision. He wanted to go to a place where he could fit in and have a coach that believed in him, and he believed in the coach, and he picked it. So at the end of the day, we got to support him as a family.
You know this game real well. What's one strength and one weakness?
His strength is the ability to, you know, think the game, play the game the right way. His weakness is, you know, he just got to keep getting better, you know, defensively as far as team defense. But that'll come as Jay Wright teaches him.
Got any good stories about Jalen and Jay with the Bulls?
Yeah, I was the best player on that Bulls team in practice.
hey, tell Rick Brunson I need my Corvette back. He bought my Corvette for about 3.5 months.
That's what you do to a rook.
I know, you guys did a lot more than that.
always love checking in with Rick Brunson. Had a 9-year NBA career, played for John Chaney at Temple before that, and had time overseas, and he's taught his son very, very well. Hey, we saw Jalen Brunson last year, 54 points for Stevenson High School against Jahlil Okafor and Whitney Young in the state championship, state tournament. No surprise, we got another good Chicago player playing here. Okafor, Alexander, Tyler Ulis, Jabari Parker, Anthony Davis, Wayne Blackshear, D. Rose, Iman Shumpert. These are all guys from here playing on this stage that are going to make an impact in college. Nice floating shot by the future Memphis Tiger, Dedrick Lawson.
Yes, it was.
For Brunson now, Villanova, they lose Darren Hilliard, they lose Javon Pinkson, but they do return Dylan Ennis, Josh Hart comes back, Ryan Archidiakono, Daniel Oshefu, who really blossomed this year, yep. Most definitely offensively and defensively. So, you know, I think he's going to come in right away. The ball is going to be in his hands with Ryan Archidiakono, and that's what Jay Wright loves to do. They play small ball, they get after you defensively. It really is applicable to the mindset that Jalen Brunson brings to the floor.
This kid Diallo is a GPS. Oof. The basketball just finds his hands. Good finish off the offensive rebound down low.
He's got 6 in the second half, 14 points for the game, and 8 rebounds as well for Sheck Diallo. Undeclared, number 11 player in the country, top 4 power forward. Brunson to Bragg, an open 3 for the lead. Slap back out towards the top, loose to Brunson. Trier, a 3 for the lead, and he got it down. West on top. 13 points for the future Arizona Wildcat.
I appreciate the unselfishness. A lot of times, playing against the top players around the country, tough to get familiar with where they like the basketball, their strengths and weaknesses. I appreciate the fact that each of these guys are looking to make the guy around them better.
Hey, Diallo is on the ball once again. Here's Brunson. Trier wanted it up top. Brunson, the Superman, the two-hand stuff.
Well, you know Jalen trusts him because he let him jump over the top of him, so it's only right.
That's right, the selfie dunk you saw at halftime. Dwayne Bacon, the future Knoll, puts down 2. There's a timeout called for the East by Bruce Kelly of the Bullish School out of Potomac, Maryland. Bruce Kelly is the coach for the East today, along with Bob Brown and Marcus Townsend, and then Robert Smith is the head coach for the West out of Simeon High School.
You see a little pass by Brunson right here behind the back to Steven Zimmerman. Zimmerman is the most skilled big man in this class. I mean, he can play both in the low post and the high post. He can knock down a 3-point jumper. He's a great runner, he can run the floor. You can see why his list is likes of KU, Kentucky, UCLA, Arizona, or UNLV. Now,
talk about UNLV here.
His mother, Lori Zimmerman, actually was the same classmate of the head coach of UNLV and Dave Rice. They graduated in 1991 together. And him being in there, being from that area, a lot of people are thinking that Zimmerman is going to go to UNLV, but he's made it a very adamant statement that he is, as you see,
the selfie dunk,
that, you know, all these other schools are still on his list, and he has not made a decision yet.
Steven Zimmerman, when he was a freshman, I remember you and I were sitting at Hoop Hall in Massachusetts watching him play with Shabazz Muhammad, who ended up being an MVP of this game.
I'm glad Shabazz got those birth certificate issues.
Oh, Lord.
Cold-blooded. There's Swanigan at the top.
Changing the subject.
Let's segue this to so naturally. Rap throwing it down. Beautiful feed by PJ Tosher. I get paid to sit next to these two guys. This is how awesome my night is, man. This is awesome. Great game, too. 64-61. West on top. A half dozen dunks apiece. 5 minutes into the second half in what's been a competitive game. Antonio Blakeney off target. Future LSU Tiger. And a shot.
I like that. And that's the kind of mentality you should have right there. Ben Simmons is the top player in this class, but Ivan Rabb has something to say about that.
No question. You guys get tangled up, you turn around, and you look at that license plate number.
Some of the intensity we're seeing on the floor. Some of the smiles, too, here in Chicago. This game has taken him from Seattle to Dallas to OKC to Tulsa, and now the Finley Prep star, Alonzo Trier, is having a great game on his way to play for the Arizona Wildcats. Big night tonight for Alonzo Trier. He's put together 13 points, 4 rebounds as well in this game. And Alonzo is with Quinn Kesnick right now.
Alonzo, you said it all started with you and your mom, Marcy, and some of those practice sessions. Describe them.
Definitely, man. Started when I was a young kid. My mother used to take time out of her day to, you know, to rebound for me every day. I would make 500 shots every day.
What's it going to take for Arizona to get over the top? What's your role?
My role would be come in, you know, to compete right away, come in and try to be effective on the offensive end and lock in on defense.
You've been focused all week and working hard. What is the biggest lesson that you've learned this week?
I've just learned about, you know, coming in and giving back, affecting lives, not just on the basketball court, but with us as human beings and players.
Where's that winning attitude come from?
This comes from my competitiveness from starting when I was a little kid, and my motivation is from my mother and God.
Thank you, Alonzo. Adam?
Really classy kid to talk to. Alonzo's been great this week with us. 64-63. Blakeney for the East puts him back on top with four consecutive points.
I can't stress enough how don't just look at the work ethic and the skill and attribute that to why these young men are being successful. I really appreciate how their faith, their philanthropic endeavor, how genuine they are about being good people. And just so happened that they're really talented basketball players.
You really have to appreciate it. And we're lucky because we spend 3-4 days with these kids. And we get to hang around them. We get to talk to them. We get to interview them. It may not always translate, or you may not always get the sense for these kids sitting at home just watching 20 minutes and 20 minutes of basketball. We get that sense, and it's really great, especially like you've talked about the social media age, how classy and humble and grounded a lot of these kids are.
These kids are byproducts of their backgrounds, and it came a long way. And, you know, I got some beef, Adam. I got some beef.
Hit me with it, man.
At JM Howe 12, at JM Howe 12, tweeted me and said, college athletes should not be paid. A free education is paying them enough. So Jay Billis did an article with the Wall Street Journal. And just to give you some facts, you see Jaylen Brown fly here. All right. Last year's games averaged 10.5 million viewers, with more than 21.2 million viewers, fans tuning into the NCAA championship between University of Kentucky and Connecticut last year. Okay. The National College Athletic Association, the NCAA,
nonprofit,
will rake in $800 million from the broadcasting rights to this year's tournament.
That's up from
a more than 500% increase from two decades ago. Yet this represents a mere sliver of the nearly $12 billion in revenues that flow annually through college athletic programs.
That's directly from the Wall Street Journal.
Quote from the Wall Street Journal. Are you kidding me that these players are being exploited? Like, now, granted, it could be capitalism, tell me whatever you want to call it, but maybe we should structure something where we should incentivize education. Maybe we should say whatever program, whatever revenue that program generates, let's put that revenue aside. Let's put an escrow. Let's give a small percentage to the player and incentivize the player by saying, okay, if you graduate with this GPA, you are incentivized to this small percentage that's been left in escrow for these 4 years and incentivized education, actually. But you can't sit here and say anymore that a free education is enough. It's not. Not when these coaches are signing $6, $7 million deals and have shoe contracts that are out of control. It's not.
Apparel deals. Jaylen, on the Grant Lab basketball hour, I remember you telling the guys something. How many revenue streams do coaches have?
You get paid from the school. You pay from the shoe company. You can have a television deal, a radio deal, your own likeness. You have the opportunity to do endorsements and appearances.
Your own fantasy camp.
I remember you distinctly saying this, and that stuck out to me, the revenue streams for these coaches. Newman gets fouled by Simmons. Still enjoying Ben Simmons, number one player in the country, doing it at both ends of the floor. We call him a positionless player because he can play any position, and he's done a lot of good things tonight. The block here at one end.
I appreciate the players diving on the floor multiple times to come up with loose balls. See, scrappy for the loose ball. Drops a dime for the easy dunk.
To his future teammate, Antonio Blakeney at LSU, part of the number six recruiting class in the country. I think it's an important discussion. We just scratched the surface of it. There's a lot more detail that I'm sure is involved and will be delved into over the course of the next several years of this argument. So, you know, don't crush the three of us for trying to solve the world's problems in just one night. But, I think it's an important conversation. You guys articulated it well.
It will happen. There was a time in collegiate basketball where players did get meal money or a stipend.
Simmons, the floater, giant killer from 15.
That had icicles.
That's part of his versatility. And you don't see a lot of guys at 6'9", 6'10", that have floaters in their game. Not only his vision, but his ability to finish around the rim and make players around him better shows you why Ben Simmons is such a special player. He's running the point right now. You have Antonio Blakeney running the two.
Again, this guy's 6'9". He's the best passer in the class, according to Paul Biancardi. Jaylen Brown, number two player in the nation. How about that? You get the top two players in the country playing together. That's still pretty cool. Trying to back down Blakeney. Nice move, and runs into Swanigan, who gets called for the foul. We'll get to know Ben Simmons a little bit. Originally from Australia, moved to Florida at Montford Academy in January of 2013. Paul Biancardi says he's a legit number one. The NBA loves his size, his versatility. He's listed as a power forward, but he can play any position. Son of Dave and Julie, one of six kids. He'll talk with us when you come back to Chicago. The LSU Tigers, Johnny Jones, head coach. Two of the best prospects in the country are on their way to Baton Rouge. The number one player in the country is Ben Simmons. Antonio Blakeney is the number 14 player, number two shooting guard in the nation. And those two guys have done some nice things so far. There's Blakeney, and now Quinn Kesnick is with the number one player, Ben Simmons.
That was what we thought your best run of the evening. How were you able to turn it up a notch?
Just sharing the ball. I'm trying to play as a team player. That's how I play. So it's a bit different playing with guys who are, just trying to score and not pass the ball. But at the same time, we're good at trying to win. So
what do you think it's going to be like going to LSU, where you will be the face of the program?
For me, I think it'll be good as a freshman, but I'm just trying to be a leader going in. I know it's hard being one of the youngest guys, but me and Antonio going in, we're going to try and lead the team.
Yeah, I was going to ask you about Antonio next. Is that comforting?
Definitely. He's a scorer, so I like to pass the ball. He can shoot the outside shot, so it's good. We work well together.
Growing up in Australia, did you even know about the McDonald's All-American game?
I've heard of a few games, but I didn't know it was this big.
Different time change. You'd probably have to wake up pretty early to watch it, Adam.
Definitely.
No doubt about it. Former rugby player, former Australian rules football player. His dad, Dave, was a player as well. Played internationally. This is what the LSU class is sitting at. Number six in the country, Simmons and Blakeney, Jarrell Martin, Jordan Mickey, both declaring for the NBA draft. It'll be a little bit more guard heavy, perhaps, with Tim Quarterman and Keith Hornsby still there. We'll see what LSU has in store for the rest of an improving SEC. Seven teams in the top 25 in the recruiting rankings. Dwayne Bacon is able to put it in. He's talking about undeclared guys. Jaylen Brown, the number two player in the nation, still undeclared. He's with Jay Williams.
Here with Jaylen Brown. Jaylen, obviously you're undecided. What's going into your decision? Why are you waiting?
I'm just taking my time with the process. It's a lot of the things that go into your decision. I'm just trying to have fun with it and just try to make the best decision possible.
What's your experience been like this week? And have you been trying to make a statement, proving to everybody that you are the top player in the class?
Yeah, man, I've been having a good time. You're not going to see another event with all these players on the floor like this. So I'm just trying to have fun with it. Hopefully you can pull out a win.
Last question, who are you rooting for in the Final Four? This is great, because I got Isaiah Briscoe to my right. I got Luke Kennard to my left. Luke Kennard's going to Duke. Isaiah Briscoe is going to Kentucky. So I'm trying to who's your favorite team? Who are you picking to win it?
I'm going with Kentucky.
All right, there you go, Adam. I don't know if that's a precursor. I don't know.
He said Kentucky is the best program in the country. He's got to find out if it's the best program for him, which I thought was a pretty mature way to approach that subject.
At this point of his life, where he chooses to go to school, that's the biggest decision. So take your time.
Here is Lawson for three. Soft Chicago rims. Just couldn't get the final bounce in a region foul against Sheck Diallo.
That's because he had a nice follow through. You get the ball when you have a nice follow through. Always follow through, especially when you're in front of the basket.
Talk to me, Jay Rose, if you're a fan of the West and how it's going to be won. OKC, Memphis, Portland, LA, part of NBA Friday presented by State Farm.
What a good thing is three of those teams have all-stars pitchers. One of those teams have Jeremy Lin pitching.
I'm sorry, man. I love Jeremy Lin, too. That was cold-blooded. That's coming your way Friday. Dwayne Bacon coming to the rim. Diallo could not clean it up. Bacon tipped it back up and in for Florida State.
I like Jeremy Lin as well.
Yes, yes.
But that's the difference between analyzing high school players, collegiate players, and professional players.
Yes.
When your team is going to the lottery, it's not for a national basketball analyst to act like he's on the team staff. They have a terrific team. They won 16 championships. I hate to see Kobe Bryant injured. We know the Lakers are going to be back. Hated to see Julius Randle get injured.
Right.
But this year, we got ping pong ball.
Should Kobe lay it down, man?
Never.
Never?
Mm-mm.
Are you just saying that because you did an interview with him on Friday?
No, I'm saying that because he was averaging 25 this year.
I love Kobe. When do you call it quits?
He getting $25 million to play basketball.
I'm just asking. I'm trying to stir the pot, just asking.
Thomas Bryant, undeclared, at the line. Could make a decision by the end of the week, he said. Indiana is recruiting him the hardest. Missouri is recruiting him. Syracuse and Kentucky haven't really made a ton of contact with him as of late. He's talked with Yogi Ferrell. He talked with James Blackman, Robert Johnson, Troy Williams. Says he's happy Tom Crean is getting the vote of confidence from Indiana. So, Thomas Bryant, could we see him with the Hoosiers? And maybe how does it impact it?
I think so. And obviously, you know, you think about the Hoosiers and that guard play that they have.
Bacon to Diallo. Smooth. Keep going.
But I think that Indiana made the right decision in keeping Tom Crean.
Yep.
Obviously, this year was a little bit of a struggle, but he's done nothing but win there at that university. And I get that all these universities want to win, but there's also a rebuilding process that each school has to go through, and he's able to do that.
I appreciate what Bryant learned from his high school coach. Why be average? It's as close to the bottom as it is to the top.
Yeah. Bacon to Diallo. It's been fun to watch these guys go to work. Diallo's got 16 points and 10 rebounds in this game. He's been one of the stars so far. 83-72, the score right now.
You know what would be awesome right now? A large order of hot McDonald's fries with extra salt. That's a request for next year.
Big shout out to Worldwide West. Worldwide West in the building here behind us. The most interesting man on the planet.
You want to know where that name came from?
Where?
I was sitting on the airplane, and we were waiting for a passenger. And the plane was being held. Wes comes walking on the plane. It was him. And right then, I came with the term, Worldwide West.
Nice.
That's so you're the one I came up with
you it? You coined it.
100%.
All you right. coined it. And Jay-Z uses it in songs, and now everybody knows who Worldwide West is. That's power. Jalen Rose has some power.
Everybody knows who Worldwide West is, but nobody knows who Worldwide West is. It's amazing. Man.
That was the most philosophical thing Jay Williams has said all night long today.
There's a lot more impressive. Where that came from.
Can't wait. Can't wait for the next 9 minutes of Zen mastering from Jay Williams. It's going to be great. Here is Diallo right off the inbounds taking a jumper. Bacon tried to grab it, and here comes Malachi Richardson, the only Syracuse commit, blocked by Lawson. Brunson to the inside, flipping it. Can't get it to fall. And here comes numbers for the East. Diallo with Bryant. Diallo spinning! Left hand laid it in!
I'm a huge fan of Diallo. I talked about it earlier in the game. A will player, because he's going to continue to compete, take charges, block shots, rebound the basketball, but he also shows the skill. Here he is in transition.
18 points for Shek Diallo.
Making the play. Jalen Brunson goes for the steal, gets put in the spin cycle, finishes with the left.
B button right there, 85-72, East on top with the ball. Evans trying to drive, and Juwan Evans out of Dallas nearly put one home, headed to Oklahoma State. One more look, man.
Initially, I thought he was going to drop it off for the dunk. He said, nah, this McDonald's All-American. I'm taking this easy deuce.
Most recent commit of the 24 guys in this game is going to Maryland. That's Diamond Stone. He's with Jay Williams.
Diamond, why Maryland?
You know, I just feel like it was the right place for me. You know, I like Coach Church as a coach. You know, I like, you know, Romello Trimble's a great point guard. You know, I feel like he'll give me the ball.
Now, you gave the ref out there a black eye. He's hurting. He said you elbowed him. Literally, the ref has a black eye. How'd that happen?
Man, I don't know, to be honest with you. You know, I just looked over, and he was just gushing. It was just black. You know, I was just looking, I didn't know what to do. So, you know, he told me, you know, I gave him a black eye, and I was just like, pointing out my muscles. You know,
no flex zone.
No flex zone.
Always. All right. There you go, Diamond Stone.
I guess Steve Hanacki should have known better in the no flex zone. Look at the left eye shiner right there for Steve, man.
And in the Big Ten, he's going to tighten and tone up, yep. Work on his body, get in shape, and be a force.
That's something he said he needed to work on, has to get his body fat percentage down to about 10. It's at about 13, 14 right now. And he's going to be part of a very good front court. Robert Carter's the transfer from Georgia Tech coming in. You hope Devontae Dodd can put on some weight. They'll still have Lehman and Nickens on the perimeter, along with Melo Trimble, who's coming back.
Look, Diallo showing on the pick and roll, rotating back to the paint.
No! Trier.
That's exactly what you do to a shot blocker.
15 points for the future Wildcat. Bacon was looking for Diallo, maybe not clean on that. And Alonzo Trier with the right hand. is followed up by P.J. Dozier.
Yeah, Evans was a little shaken up on the previous play.
Yep. 7-20.
Well, the McDonald's game is the gold standard of high school all-star games. Every player dreams about being in this game.
Number 23.
Lobs to Garnett for the dunk.
We are witnessing greatness.
Welcome to the 2015 McDonald's All-American Game from Chicago, Illinois. Fifth consecutive year we are at the United Center. This game has been played every year since 1978. We see 24 of the best high school basketball players in the country as the East meets the West. Delighted to be courtside with Chicago lineup tonight. Adam Amin, a couple of ex-McDonald's All-Americans, Jay Williams, Jalen Rose. You guys know how important this game is, how important this game can be, not just for these guys, but for everybody watching.
A celebration of greatness, a reward for your hard work. And this is an interesting time because baseball hasn't started. We're forcing a lot of football topics, even though the season doesn't start until September. Pay attention to the stars of tomorrow, right. Tonight.
I think we need more of me in the background here.
Yeah, we don't have enough, clearly.
You know what? You know why you come to a game like this? You come to a game like this to be part of this. Be part. Look at that. Look at Jay Rose right there.
Yes, indeed.
The Fab Five right there. That's why you come to games like this, to be part of greatness. And you know what? We're going to get a chance to see the next Fab Five. I'm not saying there's going to be another Fab Five, but the next players in this generation to take this game to a new level.
Number two player in the country, still undeclared. One of eight undeclared players. Jaylen Brown was awesome yesterday.
I'm a huge fan. It was almost like the last year. For me, it was Emmanuel Mudiay last year and Stanley Johnson. This gentleman is like a combination of the two. Competes on the defensive end, picks up 94 feet. You see the athleticism finishing over the top. A knockdown three-point shooter off catch and off dribble will be a special player.
Jaylen Brown and Ben Simmons were by far the best players here yesterday in the scrimmage. And Ben Simmons, Ben I Am Simmons is what I call him. 6'9", 225 pounds. They call him Mr. Versatility. He is great, can rebound a basketball, extremely athletic, has big-time vision, good athleticism. This makes everybody else around him better.
He's going to LSU. He's talking with Quinn Kesnick now.
Ben, how do you handle the pressure that goes along with being the number one player in the country?
To me, there's no pressure. You know, I don't allow myself to put pressure on myself. I'm here to have fun. I'm in Chicago Bulls Arena on ESPN, so I'm ready to play.
A lot of fans across the country watching you for the first time. What do you hope they see?
Just my versatility. I'm trying to put on the show with, you know, Blakeney, Jaylen Brown, but we're going to have fun.
Good luck. Adam.
Starting lineups for tonight and the East. Brown, the top undeclared recruit. Blakeney, a teammate of Ben Simmons, going to LSU. Isaiah Briscoe is the only Kentucky commit in this game. Diamond Stone's going to Maryland. Here's the rest of the East roster as well. Duke represented by one of the best pure shooters in the country in Luke Kennard. Two very good undeclared bigs in Shaq Diallo and Thomas Bryant. Meanwhile, for the West, Brandon Ingram can fill it up. P.J. Dozier can fill it up. Malik Newman can fill it up. Swanigan's probably the best post player here. And the rest of the West looks like this. Malachi Richardson is the only Syracuse Orange in this game. And then Jalen Brunson is on his way to Villanova. His dad, Rick, was an All-American in this game back in 1991.
In relation to Ben Simmons, you know you're big time when ESPN holds off the tip to do an interview with you before the game even starts.
This is P.J. Dozier trying to help build up South Carolina's recruiting class for Frank Martin. Going down to Caleb Swanigan, who is undeclared. A lot of very good bigs in this game that we'll see. Here's the number one player. He's positionless. He can do everything. And he kicks to Blakeney, his future LSU Tiger teammate.
Eight players in this game are undeclared, and a lot of people are still waiting for to see what happens with Kentucky. Some teams still in the Final Four. People jockeying for position, seeing who's going to decide to declare early for the draft.
Little step back, Malik Newman pushing off of Blakeney.
You see two air balls early. Sweaty palms, a lot of nerves, sure. Big crowd, NBA arena. The players will settle in.
as you see the missed layup right there.
Isaiah Briscoe on his way to Kentucky. Here's the push. Dozier to Ivan Rabb, who is also undeclared out of Oakland, California. We'll see a lot of pace, a lot of high octane, a lot of energy, some nervous energy, but we're going to get a chance to see all of it tonight.
Ivan Rabb, a special talent as well, considering thinking about going to Arizona and Cal, the two teams on his list. Arizona, today some interesting news. Rondae Hollis-Jefferson decided to leave early for the draft. Opens up for a spot for a guy like Ivan Rabb.
Brandon Ingram, also undeclared out of Kinston, North Carolina, number 12 player in the country, makes it 4-0 in favor of the West. Briscoe, part of the number one recruiting class in the nation, will draw the foul. Briscoe, number 13 player in the country, going to Kentucky. Little alley-oop action early. P.J. Dozier running the floor.
And that's the key when you play in an all-star game. Get as many layups and dunks as possible. Then before you know it, the open jump shot is something that you can knock down.
Kentucky again, the number one recruiting class. The rich continue to get richer. Scal Labissiere is a top five player. He's going to Kentucky. And then Charles Matthews, a very good shooting guard. And of course, with all the undeclareds that we have in this game, a lot of them have Kentucky on the list.
It's amazing when you look at the list for all these players. Jaylen Brown, Kentucky's on his list. Malik Newman, Ivan Rabb, Chuck Diallo, Caleb Swanigan, Steven Zimmerman,
yep.
Brandon Ingram. I mean, a lot of these players, almost essentially, it's like, it's just a free agency.
How much are they waiting to see what happens with the rest of the Kentucky lineup as Dozier hits a three?
If Kentucky wins the national championship, essentially John Calipari has painted Mona Lisa. It's difficult to tell any of those guys not to leave.
Sure.
How can it get any better for you?
In college, yeah.
Exactly, it can't.
And also, for all Cal critics, newsflash, the toughest thing to do in collegiate basketball is to recruit.
Yes.
Not only has he been able to do it, but he's had all of the guys buy into a team concept, has the opportunity to go undefeated and win the championship.
Diamond Stone, the most recent committee, is going to Maryland with a block. Another block at the other end as Blakeney was stuffed at the rim. And here comes the West with the long Brandon Ingram, a guy who can get to the bucket at will.
And I think you see a little more defense out here as you see the block up top. Because remember, in the scrimmage yesterday, it was a 30-point deficit.
Yeah, it was a blowout.
The West dominated the East yesterday.
Ingram trying to take it to the rim, and Diamond Stone will pick up the foul. Brandon Ingram is undeclared. Malik Newman is undeclared. Rabb, Zimmerman, Swanigan, some of the great players, all of them in the top 25 in terms of overall rankings. And a lot of things can happen. A lot of recruiting classes can change, and a lot of decisions can be made based on what these guys do, too.
Kentucky still with the number one recruiting class with only three players, and you have to think, we were talking about this before the game, Jay. For the Harrison twins, I don't know if their stock can get any better than the way they've been playing this year. I mean, if you were still talking about them potentially the end of the first round, early second round, you have to think that, Carl Anthony Towns is going to be probably the first or second pick taken in the draft. I mean, Devin Booker is talking about him being a top 20 pick. I don't know if Ulis is thinking about leaving, but I mean, you have a lot of guys in that team that are going to be projected first round picks. Willie Cauley-Stein might be the sleeper out of all of them,
sure.
The Tyson Chandler-like player.
Here is Swanigan, probably the best low post player overall in this game, according to Paul Biancardi. Good effort by Ivan Rabb to get the rebound and put the West back up by 7.
You see Simmons at 6'10",
so
coast to coast with the float on.
Number one player in the class, McDonald's player of the year, Naismith player of the year, Gatorade player of the year. However, Antonio Blakeney got Florida Mr. Basketball over his future teammate Ben Simmons. As Ingram misses, it'll go the other way.
Well, Blakeney committed to Louisville, then decommitted earlier in the year to play with Ben Simmons. Each of these guys are in the same AAU team, each one teach one. Well, I mean, Ben Simmons right here, he's going to need to do a lot of this next year for Johnny Jones at LSU. Jordan Mickey is no longer around. Jarrell Martin, both of these guys declared for the draft. It will be the Ben Simmons show next year.
Brown misses. Stone knocked it out. It belongs to the West.
And for a guy like Antonio Blakeney, that's as a guard, that's my dream. I can have my big man rebound the ball and push the ball up the court and have the versatility with his vision to find me as a spot-up shooter. I mean, you can only imagine him and Antonio Blakeney involved in pick and rolls.
Well, that's where the game has gone, having multiple players, 1 through 4 for a lot of teams, being able to advance the basketball and make a play with it.
Briscoe out of traffic, finding Blakeney.
That whole play started with Diamond Stone. Diamond Stone is so active defensively. Yesterday, he was battling people in practice. Mark Turgeon with a big-time recruit. With Melo Trimble coming back,
yep.
Jake Lehman being back in the picture. Maryland is actually going to be a team that could win the Big Ten next year. They also got Robert Carter, the transfer from Georgia Tech.
They got maybe the best front court in the Big Ten, yes, as of right now, is to put in by Antonio Blakeney.
And Diamond Stone is like a 6'10 Kevin Hart. He's always playing some kind of practical joke on somebody. A kid has a great personality.
Somebody really loves you if they name you Diamond.
Yeah.
Good look by Ingram looking for Rab. Make that Dozier looking for Rab. That'll take us to a timeout of the stay at this end of the floor. As we expect, a little bit of nerves to start. Now the offense starting to get going. 24 points on the board. And Diamond Stone is getting involved, getting the break going. Right now it's a 4-point West lead.
The 2015 McDonald's All-American Game is brought to you by McDonald's.
Starting to become very nice weather here in Chicago, Illinois. 4-point lead early for the West. For those of you watching this game with your phones and your tablets and your laptops, if you're watching, feel free to ask Jay Williams some questions that you want to hear from some of the players around this McDonald's All-American game. You can tweet at RealJayWilliams. Use the hashtag MCDAAG. Isaiah Briscoe is the only Kentucky commit in this game. He is with Jay Williams.
With Isaiah right now. Isaiah, we always know at these games there's some insider recruiting going on here. So out of the 8 undeclared players, who would you like to play with the most next year at Kentucky?
Out of the 8, I have to say Jaylen Brown.
Jaylen Brown. So you're trying to work on Jaylen Brown. Who else?
Jaylen Brown, Malik Newman. You know, he's a big player also. I just need somebody on the wing to catch and shoot.
So, all right. So we got a lot of work left to do. Okay, so what made you choose John Calipari over all the other coaches that recruited you?
You know what, Jay? Growing up watching Kentucky, you know, seeing what he did at Memphis with Tyreek Evans and Kentucky, Derrick Rose and, you know, John Wall and Eric Bledsoe, and just the mold of guards and how he just let them play. And I just think that I can see myself playing at Kentucky. You know, that's the highest stage of college basketball, and that's just something I couldn't say no to.
Does that pressure scare you a little bit?
Pressure's not my vocabulary.
I like that. Well, yep. There you go, Isaiah Briscoe. No pressure at all. He still thinks he's the best guard from New Jersey. I don't know about that. We still have a debate going on.
Roselle Catholic, my man. Roselle, New Jersey.
Coach Cal only has one McDonald's All-American. Fire that guy.
Shut it down. Shut it down. Nice kick by Jalen Brunson looking for Deonta Davis, who's on his way to Michigan State. Shek Diallo with the rebound. Luke Kennard going to Duke. Great pure shooter. Juwan Evans going to Oklahoma State. He's from Dallas. He gets the step. And with the right hand trying to flip it, it's going to be basket interference anyway on the high-flying Thomas Bryant.
You mentioned Davis, one of the best players not many people are talking about. The future Spartan.
Yeah, another Michigan guy who's right up there in terms of numbers that he put up with Jalen Rose, another Michigan guy. Malachi Richardson flipped into the corner for Jalen Brunson on a three. There is Davis, the aforementioned future Spartan, to Richardson, who couldn't get the friendly bounce. This is Juwan Evans. Dwayne Bacon, number 4 in black. You want to watch Dwayne Bacon. He's on his way to Florida State. He's been one of the most dynamic players all week long. Shek Diallo misses, and here's the undeclared big with the rebound. Zimmerman. And a steal by Diallo. He's got the best motor of anybody in this game. Took more steps than anybody in this game and got the left-handed layup down.
I love his motor, the way he competes offensively, defensively, going after boards, helping the helper, contesting shots.
I love this matchup between Jalen Brunson and Juwan Evans.
Yeah.
Juwan Evans, one of the purest point guards in this class, going to play for Travis Ford at Oklahoma State.
And there's the highest flyer that we've seen this week. Dwayne Bacon is going to Florida State. I'm telling you right now, that's a top 25 team. Monte Brandon, Xavier Rattan-Mays, and this guy in their backcourt, plus 3 7-footers again next year.
Watching Dwayne Bacon, I think if he were, players were able to leave out of high school to go into the NBA draft, I think he would be a top 10 NBA draft pick.
Paul Biancardi says he's a two-guard of the NBA waiting to happen. Alonzo Trier, the future Arizona Wildcat, knocks down the third West three. Let's go over to Quinn Kesting.
Joined by Brandon Ingram, one of 8 undecideds in this ballgame. You list 6 schools on your list. How much are you tuned right now into what's going on in terms of guys leaving early or staying?
That's a very big factor for me right now. People leaving for the NBA draft and seeing who's coming back.
who here on this McDonald's roster has been doing the best sell job?
It has to be between Carlton Bragg and Chase Jeter.
Is it tough? You're from North Carolina. Is it tough to maybe think out of state, or is the local pressure intense?
Local pressure is kind of intense, but I'm just looking for the best fit for myself.
Any kind of time frame?
I want to make a decision by the end of this month.
Excellent. Thank you, Brandon.
Local pressure. You know, you think about in Kinston, one of the top players, a lot of other great North Carolina players that came from Kinston as well, one including his AAU coach and Jerry Stackhouse.
You know what I love, and I'm looking
at T.J. McConnell. He's a senior. When you think about what this team Ashley comes back, Caleb Tarzewski comes back, Kadeem Allen, who transferred in, he's playing. I mean, with this recruiting class, Arizona's going to be right back up there again. It's not going to be too long before Sean Miller gets to the Final Four.
Here's Dedrick Lawson, the Memphis Tiger commit, taking a deep two. Kennard tried to save it, and it'll go the other way. 5:05 to play first half. The East with a six-point lead. It's been a nice back-and-forth affair so far. This is Jalen Brunson. His dad, Rick, was the MVP of the 91 All-American game. Ended up playing a season for the Bulls with the two guys sitting next to me, that 0-2-0-3 team. Jay Williams, Jalen Rose, Ricky Brunson, Marcus Fizer, and Jalen taking it all the way to the rack.
And that's why Jalen, I think, might be a little bit better than his dad. He can use the right hand, Jay.
His dad can't do anything with his right hand at all. The best pure point guard we have in this game. Always seems to be under control. Look, head up, under control, scanning the floor.
Think about where he's going, too. You talk about a point guard's dream to play for Jay Wright at Villanova. Gets a chance next year to play alongside of Ryan Arcidiacono. That's going to be another big-time time.
Oh, Steven Zimmerman with the left-hand hammer. He just threw it down right in the defender's face on the feed from Richardson. And a steal out high by Bragg. Showtime in Chi-Town.
Get up Lawrence, Kansas for Carlton Bragg. Tie game at 36. A spectacular 6-0 run, Jalen.
And Jay, you mentioned Duke and UK, the number of players they have in the Final Four. But a couple of other programs, Cloudy always recruit a few McDonald's All-Americans. Arizona and Kansas seem to come to mind. They always find a way to still be in living rooms.
Carlton Bragg next year playing alongside Perry Ellis. Probably going to be, you know, Kelly Oubre.
You think Kelly goes?
He declared.
He did declare. That's right.
You wonder about Cook Alexander, but Carlton Bragg, another guy that can be a stretch four, can space, you know, face you up, space out the defense with that jump shooting ability, and also has low post moves, very similar to Perry Ellis.
Last touch by Bragg, but he's made a nice little impact. Speaking of high impact at this end of the floor.
Powerful impact, boom! Get up for the get down. Chi-Town, we in the mix.
Let's get to know one of our undeclared players. Not from Harlem or Hollywood, he's from Jackson, Mississippi. Malik Newman with Kansas and Kentucky and LSU and Mississippi State with the new head coach Ben Howland in the mix. Maybe NC State or Ole Miss. Said he wants to take his time with his decision. I'm sure Jay Williams is going to try to poke and prod with him right now.
All right, Malik, first question I have for you comes from a guy on Twitter, Mizzy Moose. He wants to know, are you the best guard to come out of Jackson? You talk about Mo Williams, Monte Ellis, Lindsey Hunter. Are you the best guard to come out of Jackson, Mississippi?
Yeah, I think I am.
All right, next question. Your father played at Mississippi State. Obviously, Ben Howland, just a new coach there. Does that influence your decision at all?
No, not a lot at all.
All right, there you go, Malik Newman. Good luck out there.
Tight lip, Jay. I knew you were going to go investigative journalist on him, but naturally tight-lipped Malik Newman, understandably so as well.
I appreciate his innocence. If I was 6'3", 175, and averaging 31 points per game, my favorite TV show wouldn't be SpongeBob.
Naivete, innocence, youthful exuberance, Jalen.
I love it. I was watching Good Times in Sanford and Son.
No 227 on that, actually. A little disappointed. This is the number one player in the country, Ben Simmons. originally from Melbourne, Australia, moved to Florida in 2013. He's playing for Montverde Academy. You'll see him during the Dix High School Nationals this week. And Diamond Stone on his way to Maryland, the latest commit. Melo Trimble said today for sure that he's coming back. And Diamond Stone said if Melo wasn't coming back, he may not go to Maryland.
I'm a fan of Thomas Bryant and Diamond Stone. Bigs down low, traditional, stepping out, still making the open jump shots.
Ingram with a one-handed rebound, got it maybe deterred by Simmons, and then he stayed on the glass. Brandon Ingram out of Kingston, North Carolina, undeclared, doing it big here in this first half.
Looked like a slinky the way he jumped up there, grabbed that offensive board, and put it back in.
Brown took a spill. A
first
foul.
Down and 10.
Caleb Swanigan on the foul. Talk about the women's Final Four getting going. It is all number one seeds. Dawn Staley made it as a player in the early 90s. Now as a coach, she leads South Carolina against Notre Dame. And then Maryland and UConn. We saw three of those four teams represented in the girls' All-American game today. The Final Four from Tampa begins on Sunday on ESPN.
Jay, have we lost the madness all chalk in the ladies' Final Four?
It's almost
three of the four teams in the men's are number one seeds.
7-1 seeds.
And this is the year we were talking about parity exists in college basketball. Three number one seeds.
What's wrong with the cream rising to the top, though, guys? As Brown misses the free throw, and we go to Quint Kesnick with a guy who's got some hardware on the football field.
That's right. Ohio State, longtime NFL running back Eddie George. You got a great seat, first of all. Yeah. How do you put in perspective the quality of athlete you're seeing here?
Oh, it's exceptional. These guys are built. They're young. I mean, you can see how explosive they are. Just close up on the floor. It's amazing to see where they're going to be when they get in a program, get the weightlifting program underneath them. Just how far beyond they're going to be where they are right now. It's amazing.
Blakeney rejected by Ingram on that 3-on-1. What's the biggest challenge these guys are going to face between now and, let's say, start of the second semester around Christmas time next year?
I think just making the adjustment from high school to college, getting acclimated to the environment, having free time on their hands. But you know what? I think most of these guys are ready for the next level. I mean, you can see it athletically, but from a mental perspective, they have to really find some mentors, some older guys that can really take care of them, and hopefully they can make the transition easy for them.
How about number 25, Ben Simmons?
Oh, he's a man. I mean, number one player in the country. I'm looking at him like he could be a wide receiver, a hybrid tight end, outside linebacker. The same goes for Jaylen Brown. Tremendous athletes. I mean, they're so fast and explosive. It's incredible.
He's going to LSU, but not to play for Les Miles. Adam?
You know what? And Eddie George is absolutely right. Ben Simmons, he's got a really interesting background as an Australian rules football player and rugby player. No shot that Eddie George, a guy who knows what he's talking about, would say he could play on the football field. He gave those sports up at the age of 14 to really focus solely on basketball. It's been a pretty good run for him as well.
First off, every time I see Eddie George, it makes me want to go back and get in the weight room.
Get in the gym, right?
I need to start doing some push-ups or something. He still looks, it looks like he's still playing.
Yeah, man. You see Ben Simmons, what he needs to work on, though, the shooting range and the rebounding, and I imagine, and I wonder if this was the case for you guys, you get stronger from freshman year to sophomore year, you're in a full year in the weight program, that might help him a little bit.
I appreciate the humility of these players, because Jay Williams was interviewing them yesterday, and a lot of the guys, the first thing they mentioned was their weaknesses,
yeah,
things that they need to work on. A lot of times in high school, you don't have a moral or social compass. You think?
Do you say that from experience, just out of curiosity?
I'm 100% speaking from experience. And so the maturity of these young players, I really appreciate it in the era of social media,
yeah,
and so much scrutiny, having to always behave and make quality decisions and still be able to perform at a high level. We talk about them being competitive. A lot of these guys compete in the classroom. A lot of honor roll students as well.
Dozier to Ingram.
And one of those questions I asked yesterday was to Dwayne Bacon, and I said, if you could leave early right now from high school and be a top 10 pick, would you go?
That's right.
And he said, no, I think I need to become a better defender, and that's why I'm going to go to Florida State. And it takes that kind of maturity. And look, if you actually got, first off, high school players should be able to leave out of high school and go to the NBA. We need to make some changes on that.
What a noble idea.
I mean, seriously, I mean, I understand really? We want to make the college game better. So if you go to college, maybe you can stay 2 or 3 years, but you should be able to go directly out of high school.
Do you like the baseball model where you either go out of high school, or if you're going to go to college, you should commit for 2, maybe 3 years like it is in baseball?
All I know is some of the top players currently in the NBA came straight out of high school.
Sure.
Kobe Bryant, Kevin Garnett. Garnett. It's been a successful tool for a lot of players, and I think you should have the opportunity.
Well, Emmanuel Mudiay, and I saw Jay Billis on ESPN before our game tonight talking about Emmanuel Mudiay, who's somebody
top five pick.
Who's going to be a top five pick, who played in this game last year. Obviously, that was a bit of a different issue with the academics and things like that, but when you can't figure everything out for your first year of college, or you know you're going to leave after a year, do you think some guys are going to start doing what Mudiay did, go overseas, play a year, and then go to the
Brendan draft? Jennings did it before
Jennings
that.
Did it for the Bucks. Yeah,
it's going to be a trend that I think we're going to continue to see, especially if the 2017 CBA comes up and Adam Silver decides to make it a two-year maximum, you know, tier minimum in college.
Yeah.
I just always struggled with the idea that basketball and football were the only sports that had age limits and restrictions. I struggle with that.
Yeah, it's an understandable thing to struggle with because it doesn't necessarily fit in with everything else. Brandon Ingram has had one of the best first halves of anybody on the floor tonight. He's got 13. Shot clock is off. Here is Simmons against Jeter.
We're going to get into that in the second half, but the fact that coaches are making millions of dollars. I mean, contracts aren't like they used to be back 20 years ago. I mean, guys are signing multiple million-dollar years for a shoe contract. The NCAA is making money. The players should be able to get a cut of it. They should. We'll talk about that in the second half.
Briscoe to Stone to close out half number one. We'll get to know the number one player in the country, Ben Simmons, during halftime. The players get to visit the Ronald McDonald House, the fine sponsor and charity that gets all of the proceeds for this game, and, of course, the best dunks from the Jam Fest. High motor guy, Sheck Diallo, right now with Quint Kesning.
Yeah, talking about a hustler, Sheck, where does that engine come from within you?
I mean, that's a natural, like, because I used to play soccer when I was younger. That's kind of like I have a lot of energy and I'm fast too.
Are you aware that the teams that you're considering are watching this game?
I mean, I think so, yes.
Is that motivation?
Yes, motivation, yeah.
When do you expect to make a decision?
I mean, I'm waiting for something like maybe April after Jordan game or before Jordan game.
You keep blocking shots, your phone's going to be ringing off the hook. Adam.
Great first half. 8 points, 7 rebounds, couple blocks as well for Sheck Diallo, a native of Mali, who is going to make somebody very happy. Maybe Kentucky or Kansas or Iowa State or St. John's with new head coach Chris Mullin or Jamie Dixon at Pitt. High octane, a lot of scoring, 49-46. It's a lead for the East at the halftime break. We'll see some of the best dunks from the Jam Fest during the halftime. We'll get to know Ben Simmons. All that coming up after this 3-point game from the Shot. Back in Chicago, halftime of the McDonald's Boys High School All-American Game. It's been a very interesting path from Australia to Florida to here in Chicago for the number one player in the country, Ben Simmons.
My path coming over to the States and being an All-American has been long, but to start it off, I came over here for a few camps, Adidas Nations 2012. I was just having fun with it, just playing and enjoying the game with my friends, and then coming to America and being on a highlight video, that was big enough for me, just being in like a 3-second clip of me dunking a ball, that was crazy. So from there, it just kind of took off. I wanted to, play in America because the competition is a lot higher and the players are more athletic physically. So I think for me, it was just getting better and finding a way I could just improve my game. Well, my dad played professionally in Australia, Belgium, all over Europe. So he's a big basketball person. He's had all the experiences and he is from New York. So being American, I'm half American. And just living in Australia, I think he taught me the Australian side and the American side, how to play the games. The most common question I get is, do you have kangaroos in front of your backyard?
And what do you tell them?
Of course, nah. being player of the year is definitely an honor. There's so many guys at this event that are great players and who have played really well this season, but I've just been blessed enough that I was given the award, and I think it has a lot to do with my family, my parents, my teammates, and coach. Back home, I usually go back to my old primary school and go talk to them, so a lot of those guys that I was at school with, are now teenagers, so it's good to go back there and just talk to them, tell them my experiences, all about being over in America and playing basketball. Being a part of this event. It means a lot just being able to go to the Ronald McDonald's house and seeing, you know, I met a friend today, Bradley, so that was an eye-opener for me. It's just good to give back. I think for me, I know a lot of this stuff happens off the court. You know, being a good person is more important than being a good basketball player.
Some great stuff from Ben Simmons. We've had a lot of fun this week. Coming up, we'll see the top dunks from Monday night's Powerade Jam Fest. Beautiful night in Chicago. It's halftime of the McDonald's Boys High School All-American Game. It's been a great week. A lot of great events make up this week, including the Skills Camp. There's Mike Dunleavy, the current NBA star, former McDonald's All-American himself. He paid a visit this week as part of the McDonald's All-American Skills Clinic. This clinic engages kids and families from the community while promoting some fun and physical activity. A lot of tips on a variety of fundamentals, lessons on having a little fun, too. It's made for a great day of learning and development. Maybe an All-American of the future.